Or call 844-450-2273. That's 844-450-2273. This plan is not insurance. Members pay participating providers and receive discounts immediately. Savings will vary by provider and service. Cancel within 30 days to get a full refund less processing fee. Discount Medical Plan Organization is Carrington International Corp, Frisco, Texas. This plan is not available in all areas. Call 844-450-2273 or go to mydiscounthealth.com.
A New Jersey man's been indicted on burglary charges after police say he inadvertently dialed 911 and let authorities in on his plans. We get the latest from Bob Agnew.
Police say they heard Scott Robert Esser and an accomplice talking about breaking into homes, emptying drawers, and making off with goods. The 42-year-old Esser was indicted on burglary, theft, and other charges in connection with burglaries in several cities. Esser was arrested July 29th on the Garden State Parkway. At the time, police say they found jewelry, electronics, and more than $11,000 in bonds and a handgun in his car. Bob Agnew reporting.
Planned Parenthood is denouncing a fire that heavily damaged one of its clinics as an appalling act of violence. Investigators determined that the blaze in Pullman, Washington was caused by arson. It follows a recent wave of protests at Planned Parenthood clinics across the country. News and analysis at townhall.com. I'm Ron DeRockstra. Marion County, Oregon, Judge Vance Day is being investigated by a judicial fitness commission in part over his refusal to perform so-called same-sex marriages on religious grounds.
What a federal court ruling in May 2014 made so-called same-sex marriage legal in Oregon, Day instructed his staff to refer same-sex couples looking to marry to other judges. Last fall, he decided to stop performing weddings altogether. The investigation of Day comes amid heightened national attention to the responsibilities of public officials who are asking for religious accommodations. Patrick Foss reporting.
California's biggest wildfire this year is expected to spew smoke through the Labor Day weekend, leaving roads closed and some campgrounds empty. The fire burning in Kings Canyon National Park east of Fresno grew overnight to 134 square miles. Officials say it's about 25% contained. More on these stories at townhall.com.
Are your Google search results killing you? Unflattering content in blogs, news articles, online reviews, social media, or other sources can jeopardize your reputation, your business, and your livelihood. Let Reputation.com help. Our patented technology will make the truth about you more visible while pushing down unwanted negative content. Improve your Google search results. Call Reputation.com at 1-800-831-0771 for a free consultation. That's 800-831-0771.
By now, you know the smart way to buy emergency food storage is calories per dollar. Ready Supply Foods sells you 50% more food for your money. GMO-free, 25-year shelf life, great tasting, and free shipping. You need 2,000 calories per day under ideal conditions. Most 30-day kits don't have enough calories to sustain you for more than a week. They just don't have enough nutrition to do the job. See the comparisons for yourself at ReadySupplyFoods.com. We are the new leader in value and quality. Go to ReadySupplyFoods.com today.
Live, you may join us here on the radio waves. You are invited, and you can bring up anything that happens to be on your mind. With you in the studio tonight, it's Ian.
And Mark.
We've got Skype. You can Skype into the show. Username there, lrn.fm. We'll give you the toll-free lines as well. Donald Trump, who you guys talked on the Thursday night edition, Mark. I was not on that show, but apparently you talked about how Donald Trump has now signed some sort of an agreement with the Republican Party to basically fall in line.
Well, he said that he's not going to run as an independent. He has signed an agreement, which, of course, is a...
Didn't the agreement also say that he would endorse the party's nominee?
Yes. He would. No, he would support the party's nominee.
It's kind of the same thing, right?
Well, I felt like the piece of paper could have been written better. I would have used the term endorse, and I would have said that instead of he couldn't seek the nomination of a third party, because it said he couldn't run independent and he couldn't seek the nomination of a third party. Well, what if a third party seeks his nomination, seeks him as the candidate? So that kind of leaves a hole there, and it leaves a hole in that it says he has to support. I support my esteemed colleague here on the stage with whom I am debating. However, he is wrong on this issue, and this issue, right? Like, so that
maybe
could be done.
Maybe. I guess we'll see how that pans out. But to me, it really just removed any kind of good things that I might have said about Donald Trump, because previously, the things that I had to say that I liked about him was that when he was on the Republican debate, he was the only person on the stage, not even Rand Paul, who was saying that he would not support, not necessarily support the eventual nominee, whoever that person was, right? Like just sort of blind, I will support whoever the nominee is. He was the only one who said he would not do that. And to me, that seemed to be a little bit of integrity, and I praised him for that, but now he's wiped all that away. So, well, really, he's got nothing going for
you're
him.
You're a third-party guy from way back. And
I'm
so
a freedom guy, actually. Yeah, well, whoever's the freedom candidate.
But you were, you worked with the Libertarian Party and those sorts of things. But I understand why parties choose to try to keep their sort of candidates in line. I get why
a major
party would not want somebody running first in their primary and then running in the general after they don't do so well. I get why they would want that. Like, here, pick a party and go with that for this election, okay?
I just wonder what they did to get him to change his mind about that. Because it seemed like a big change for him. And I guess the other thing about Donald Trump is his anti-immigration rhetoric. Honestly, I haven't paid a lot of attention to it, but Forbes magazine has been doing this.
Yeah, and to some extent, he's made immigration the most talked about issue in this,
election. It's always a hot issue. And it's certainly the case that Trump has been focusing on it.
Immigration, our immigration policy could be changed to jumpstart this economy and change America. Of course, what Donald Trump is proposing will not do that.
He wants a police state, total police state.
He might be a good businessman. He just doesn't understand economics in the same way.
So there's a story here over at Forbes, and you've got a plan, Mark, that I want to talk about.
Yeah, I've got a plan.
A blue card plan.
Yeah, it's a somewhat statist plan. It's a tipping your toe and you're putting your foot in the water of freedom as opposed to jumping in.
It's compromised.
Yeah, it's certainly that. Yeah.
Do you want to talk about that now?
Oh, sure. Absolutely. Right, I'll go right ahead and do that.
Because I can talk about Trump, but we'll get into him.
Well,
later.
Yeah. So all I'm saying is that, look, you can use the immigration issue to jumpstart the economy and to stop the problem of jobs being shipped overseas. Why are jobs being shipped overseas? Because wages here are significantly higher than they are elsewhere.
Sure. And regulations.
We also have a problem with minimum wage driving people out of the marketplace. Young people are not in the marketplace because they can't compete against older people who are working for minimum wage trying to feed families currently. Mm-hmm. Things are turning around a little bit with this economy, but they haven't turned around yet. A lot of people would like to see that happen. So here's what I suggest. I suggest that first you got to stop all foreign intervention. You don't want to open up the borders and make it easy for people to come here if you're out there bombing people and creating enemies. So you got to stop the foreign intervention and let people in other countries figure out what they're going to do. This is actual cost savings because it doesn't cost us taxpayers money to build tanks and bombs and missiles and all the things that
$1 trillion for the war in Iraq or whatever.
Right. War's incredibly expensive. It does not jumpstart the economy.
Yeah.
I would like anyone to tell me how it does.
It makes it worse.
And that number is 855-450-3733. If you think war stimulates the economy, I'd like to talk to you about that.
That's toll free number. It's 855-450-FREE.
So you stop the foreign interventions and you let people come into this country. You give them a blue card. The blue card, counts them at the border. We know who they are and all that stuff. They're going to be, they're going to be working. They're going to be working under a different system. They won't be eligible in any way, shape, or form for government welfare programs. And that includes everything.
Does that mean they don't get to pay into them too?
I think that's fair.
Yeah.
It seems fair to me that if you don't.
Because I'm opting out too.
Right. And I think that any American citizen who wants a blue card should be able to get it too.
Sweet.
And to opt out. So you can opt out of the minimum wage, you opt out of the government welfare programs. Well, in the case of taking the blue card, an immigrant wouldn't have any choice but to take the blue card, right? And then essentially they get, they don't. they work. They can work for less if that's what they want to do, and if they can negotiate higher wages, just like I do. Anybody who works for more than minimum wage has negotiated higher wages. So that is quite possible to do, and we can see how it would work in that environment. However, there would be downward pressure on wages, and you would see then, instead of people, you know, jobs being shipped overseas for low-wage jobs, you'd have them here in the United States. Yeah, you'd probably have some sections of town and some places around the United States where, you know, it wouldn't be as nice as it is in Key Largo or, you know, Beverly Hills. But, you know, people would live there and they'd have jobs and they'd be happy. I mean, let's take a look at East St. Louis right now. Let's take a look at Detroit. Let's take a look at the Rust Belt entirely. There's a lot of houses where people, you know, they're not very nice sections of town where people could be living and raising family in these homes. So essentially that's it. They just opt out and they
So the blue card, you get it. You can get it as an American. You can also get it as somebody who wants to come here. The blue card allows you to not have to pay into the system, but you also can't withdraw from the system.
You get nothing as far as government assistance. As far as I'm concerned, that goes with government schools. That goes for mandates from hospitals and emergency rooms and those sorts of things. Those people can set up their own mutual aid societies. They can get help from churches and charities and those sorts of things.
Now, what's the blue card going to cost?
I don't see why it should cost anything.
Well, the current system, Mark, you've got to pay application fees and you've got to hire attorneys and it can take years. I've got show prep we're probably not going to get to, but guy says he's tried for 15 years to get into the United States.
It should take for somebody to be processed at the border. It should take about 15 minutes for them to take down their name and whatever identifying information that they have from them. I think that they probably are going to have to identify themselves in some shape or form. So it should take the government bureaucrat 15 minutes. So whatever a government bureaucrat of a low-level functionary that does data entry might cost in 15 minutes. So I'm going to say $10.
And the United States federal government would be able to save billions of dollars because you already said they wouldn't be going to war around the world at the same time. So there's other things factoring in
at that point.
So this isn't going to expand the size of government.
I don't see how it would. There's plenty of government functionaries out there now trying to keep people from coming out. Mm-hmm. Just put them to work stamping pieces of paper when people go in.
You know, it's not a bad plan, Mark. Maybe you're serious about this running for president thing. Huh?
Oh, I am. I'm also running for president. Now, this is a joke, though, but yeah. I'm giving away twice whatever Bernie Sanders is. So if you want free college, I'm giving away free master's degrees. And master's degrees in 2 years. Free doctorates.
Sweet.
For everybody. And whatever else you want free. Free medical? I'll give you a free robot exoskeleton.
Okay, so that's the joke. But the blue card's an interesting proposal. And I'm just trying to think of objections. I'm sure our listeners have them. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. The first objection that seems to be the most striking one is that, well, you just want to take jobs from Americans.
Yeah.
I mean, you want people to come in here and undercut their hourly pay. I mean, everybody's going to get fired, Mark.
Sure. If somebody can do your job, if somebody who cannot speak English very well, if at all, can take your job and do it at $4 an hour, you need a new job. Right? Like, you speak English fluently. You've been in the United States a long time. If somebody who can come in here and do your job for $4 an hour, who's never been in the country before and can't speak English, sorry. We all need to grow in order for the economy to get better.
The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. We are here live on Saturday night's edition of Free Talk Live. Join us.
This is Charlie Sundstrom with your Van Dyke Mortgage Minute with four keys to choosing a home. First, know what you can afford and how much cash you'll need before looking at any homes. This will save you the disappointment that can come along from falling in love with a property that's out of reach. Second, location. Learn about the neighborhood, sample the commute, talk to neighbors, research the schools, shops, and nearby amenities. Next, consider your range of choices. There are single-family, multifamily, townhomes, condos, and co-ops. Decide which is best for you and refine your search from there. Last, obtain a valid pre-approval before you make any offer. Your pre-approval gives you and the seller confidence in your ability to close the deal once you've found a home that's right for you. For your mortgage pre-approval and refi needs, start by visiting VanDykeMortgage.com. That's VanDykeMortgage.com.
Corporate NMLS 3035. Van Dyke Mortgage is an equal housing lender. Charlie Sundstrom, NMLS 134251.
No!
That's the sound your brain makes when you realize you're buying something and forgot the coupon. Online or in a store, knowing that you're missing a deal is the worst. You need the app from RetailMeNot right now. Get thousands of coupons from 50,000 stores like Kohl's, Domino's, Best Buy, and more with crazy deals like 60% off, free shipping, and free gifts with purchase. You can get a text invite to download the RetailMeNot app 100% free right now for Apple or Android. Just text the code UPDATE to 42767. Then just show your phone at checkout to save. It literally couldn't be easier. It's 2015. Keep your coupons in your phone. Stop what you're doing and text UPDATE to 42767. Listeners will get a text with a link to download it 100% free. Never forget another coupon again. Text the code UPDATE to 42767 right now. That's UPDATE to 42767. Message and data rates may apply. For terms and privacy, visit RetailMeNot.com.
KatieArmor.com is your one-stop shop for the most affordable body armor period. With packages starting at $169.99 and free shipping on every order. Katie offers soft armor and rifle threat rated armor up to level 4. Go to KatieArmor.com and get your body armor today while you still can. Mention this ad and receive a free tactical scarf for a limited time with any body armor package. That's CATIArmor.com. Come and take it.
It's time to build your own emergency food stockpile with the industry leader, My Patriot Supply. Once you try them, you'll know why so many Americans like you have made them part of their emergency preparedness plan. Experience the My Patriot Supply difference today with this unbelievable offer. Right now, a 4-week food supply is only $99, and that includes free shipping. That's 50% off the online price. Call 800-274-3070 to claim yours. Limit 2 per caller while supplies last. This offer isn't available online, so you want to make sure and grab this opportunity to get prepared today. 800-274-3070 to get your 4-week food supply for the incredible price of only $99, and it'll be shipped to you completely free. Call 800-274-3070 right now. That's 800-274-3070 to claim yours while supplies last. Don't wait. Call today.
Do you owe the IRS money? Has the IRS garnished your wages or put a lien against your house? The IRS has the power to make you pay back what they claim you owe and will stop at nothing to collect. There is a solution. Call Signature Tax now. Speak with our professionals and feel the weight of your tax burden lifted from your shoulders. Call now for your free and confidential analysis. 800-481-3147. Again, that's 800-481-3147. 800-481-3147.
Now more Free Talk Live. Call in toll-free at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-FREE.
This is Free Talk Live. We will, of course, take your calls about anything you want to talk about. Right now, we are on the table with a discussion of the blue card, Mark's proposal to allow more people to come here and make a better life for themselves. And I gotta say, it's, you know, for a political proposal, Mark, it's, I think it sounds pretty well. It's pretty good.
Politics isn't pretty, and you always got to make compromises.
So we're going to continue. We'll get your calls and thoughts here. Saveitpurse.com, though, is something you need to know about if you've ever shopped at Amazon or if you ever will shop at Amazon, because you could save 20% or more on your purchases at Amazon by using Bitcoin. That's the catch with saveitpurse.com. You do have to have Bitcoin in order to get a huge discount off of your Amazon purchases. I recently got the pair of headphones that I'm wearing for 29% off on Amazon. You can literally select the discount that you want. Now, the higher the discount, the longer it'll take likely to fulfill your order. But the average discount in the United States is 20%.
And that means that since Amazon has just about everything you need for your life,
at about the lowest prices you can generally find,
you can change your life, start saving significantly, and not have to drive around going to do shopping and things like that. It's a huge, huge deal.
Saveatpurse.com. Go and get started there. There's a nice little video you can watch. It'll explain it to you. It's real simple, and it works very well. Saveatpurse.com. Let's go to your calls and thoughts. Mark proposing the idea of the blue card, where people could come in, easily in a 15-minute process, basically. And, you know, they'd get this blue card, which would allow them to work and work under the minimum wage if they wanted to, if they, you know, that was an agreement they had with their employer. But at the same time, they also wouldn't be receiving or eligible to receive any kind of federal benefits either, or local or state, I presume, as well. Would opt them out of that. Is that right, Mark?
I think that the states and local municipalities would have to work that out on their own.
Okay.
From a federal standpoint, people get few benefits from the federal government.
Okay.
You know, and they wouldn't be eligible for any of those.
But they also wouldn't have to pay in. So if they, you know, weren't going to be paying, if not going to expect to receive Social Security, they shouldn't be expected to pay into it either.
That's right? Correct.
And you said that Americans would be able to apply for the card as well. So, like, to opt out, essentially, of the federal system.
I think they should be able to. I mean,
shouldn't
that be a freedom an American has?
I think so. Let's go to you with your calls and thoughts. 855-450-FREE. First up, Sue is in Vernon, Indiana. Sue, you're on Free Talk Live.
Hey, thank you for taking my call.
Hi.
This is the first time I've listened to your show.
Welcome.
I have to tell you, I almost jumped out of my car.
Oh, no.
Because I keep my radio on 97.1 and listen to Dana. The Dana Show.
Oh, okay.
And so I'm a conservative. I assumed that I was listening to a conservative program.
Ah, you know what happens when you assume, Sue.
Oh, I'm wrong.
No, you're not wrong.
Well, okay, we're more conservative than you are.
That's what I'm saying.
I am much more conservative.
Okay, well,
what does that even mean? Hold on. We can't talk about conservatism without you defining first what you mean by that.
Okay, what I'm defining is this. Number one, I'm a social and a fiscal conservative.
Okay.
I'm a retired RN, and I was born in the inner city of Chicago, Illinois. Being an RN for 33 years in the health system has enabled me to observe medical care. Your plan, very respectfully, is doomed to fail because it's very idealistic. However, you are talking about people, if they're not going to receive any benefit, that means that they virtually are going to come up, they're still going to need health care. You're assuming that people are going to sit in their homes and not seek health care for their babies and their
There's nothing wrong with people going to get health care if they're paying for it, right?
Here's what I'm assuming, madam.
No, here's my point. You're assuming that they're going to pay for it. You're assuming that they're going to have the ability to pay for it. I've seen hospitals go out of business because they don't have the ability. I've worked. Do you want to argue with me about
it? No, I don't want to argue.
No, what I want to say is that there are lots of hospitals.
What I've seen is two hospitals that have actually gone under and closed their doors.
I don't propose that a single hospital have to provide a single bit of service that they don't wish to provide, meaning if they don't get paid, they don't have to provide it. May I continue, madam? What I'm saying is that there's...
You're wrong. Go into a hospital and refuse service and see what happens. You have liability. Are you kidding?
Different program with a different status of citizenship. You sign up.
Here's another thought. You're misinforming your audience.
How so?
Is it?
Yes, it's a blue card. Have you ever heard of a blue card before?
Oh, please. Let me finish my point.
She's seen those in the hospital all the time.
The hospital's got them.
Okay. The point is this. You've made a statement that Trump is against immigration. That is the way the liberal left portrays the conservative people. Because
the liberals are against immigration, too. I don't know if you've noticed that.
Legal immigration.
Say it louder. I can't hear you.
The legal process is arduous and difficult. Your parents came here. It was so much easier.
Grandparents, probably.
Grandparents.
So don't respect the laws.
The law is words written on paper by people generally considered to be liars and thieves. Don't you consider politicians to generally be liars and thieves?
Well, I believe in the integrity of my country.
That is a dodge.
That is not an answer to the question. Do they not answer questions at the hospital?
You have You know what? You haven't answered my question.
I'll answer any question you have. I haven't yet been able to say, by the way, there are lots of charity hospitals. That's why they say St. Margaret's and St. Michael's and Saints whatever. And those people would get a treatment through charity hospitals.
Who funds them, sir?
The church does. That's why they have the word saint on them.
You know
what? There's a lot of Catholic hospitals.
Hospitals, I've worked for Catholic hospitals for 20 years.
Okay.
And they eat the loss. They take the loss. And you know what?
Yeah, that's because it's a charity hospital.
And I've worked with, it's a nonprofit, and I've worked within a system that has been overly taxed by these people.
So I'm against taxes. Are you for taxes?
No, she's saying taxes.
My children have gone to schools that don't educate properly.
You never answer my question.
Because they're government schools.
You never answer my question. You said you were conservative, but you never defined it for me. Can you do that, please?
I am conservative. I believe in going through the legal process. I respect the Constitution. I believe a conservative... I believe in a work ethic. I believe in responsible government.
And a police state.
Humane,
do you believe in a police state?
A police state. I believe in the Second Amendment. Mm-hmm. I believe in the law. Hmm. I bet you are applauding the cops that have been killed.
Oh,
I don't
no.
applaud
no,
people
I don't.
Being killed.
I don't want to see anybody being
but
killed.
But I do know that, but I can tell you that there have been, this is predictable, and we predicted it on the air. We said that at some point, if people continue to be disenfranchised by the government bureaucrats, that these sorts of things will happen. And surprise, surprise, they did.
Thanks, Sue, for your call. Appreciate it. Our toll-free number here is 855-450-FREE. I mean, I'll throw that out there to anybody else. Can you define conservative in... let's say one sentence. What's the philosophy behind it?
Mine is fiscally conservative. Where is the spending on my immigration plan?
Your blue card plan?
Yeah, my blue card plan. Where is it? If you heard the first segment.
Our toll-free number, we can sum it up here in a moment. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE, 855-450-3733. This is the live Saturday edition of Free Talk Live.
Global warming covertly describes the effects of iron poisoning. CO2 is iron poison blood types and is the body's defense mechanism to buffer the oxygen iron attracts. CO2 in blood and blood type prevalences are used as false evidence for global warming and is the setup for the greatest fraud in history. The healthy blood type AB is on the Shroud of Turin and is their DNA proof they are his Christ. For further information, unveilingthem.com, unveilingthem.com.
We are a survival company. We manufacture our own line of Level 3 and Level 3A body armor. We proudly make our armor 100% in America. We have the best prices in the nation, about $125 cheaper than our nearest competitor. All lab certified, for thou art my rock and my fortress, Psalm 31:3. We are Fortress Survival LLC.com.
Are you tired of commuting to a job that makes someone else rich, working harder than ever, but getting nowhere? Do you hate spending hundreds of dollars every week on daycare, having someone else raise your children? With our opportunities, you can start earning money as soon as next week. You get to be the boss, work from home, and live a happier life. At Be The Boss Network, you'll find hundreds of work-from-home opportunities that you can literally start today and be earning money as soon as next week. Go to freedom106.com and start earning money as soon as next week. You get to be the boss. Get out of the rat race. Work from home. Go to freedom106.com right now and change your life today. That's freedom, the number 106.com. Go to freedom106.com and start earning money as soon as next week. You be the boss. Go to freedom106.com.
Hi, this is Ted Anderson. Have you ever wondered why banks, stockbrokers, investment advisors won't talk about gold IRAs? They've been available since 1986, yet the financial industry won't recognize the value of gold for your retirement. Gold has outperformed paper investments, yet no word about IRAs. If you would like to have gold for your retirement, call 800-686-2237. Don't get left behind by rising inflation and low returns. Call 800-686-2237. Secure your future and call 1-800-686-2237.
Don't complain about your cable bill going up and up and up. Do something about it. Grab a pencil and jot down this special number. 1-855-905-MY-TV. The more cable TV rates go up, the better digital satellite TV looks. Say goodbye to the cable guy. And get more of your favorite channels in 100% digital quality for less money. Call 1-855-905-MY-TV. Sign up for packages starting as low as $19.99, and there's no equipment to buy. You get free HD TV upgrade, a free DVR upgrade, and free professional installation. You control what you watch, when you watch it. Record your favorite shows, pause and rewind live TV, even skip the commercials. Watch local channels too. At just $19.99, what are you waiting for? Pull out your major credit or debit card. Call 1-855-905-MYTV. 1-855-905-MYTV. Say goodbye to the cable guy. Cut costs and get more. 1-855-905-MYTV. 1-855-905-MYTV.
So I say to Mark at lunch, look, you know, I keep hearing from the government that, you know, they're worried someday ISIS may get here. And I go, duh, Garland, Texas, Muhammad cartoon shooting. ISIS is already here. I'm not waiting for these people to defend me. If they don't know ISIS is here already, they got no clue. I'm taking care of myself. Guns80.com, AR-15 kits, 30-shot magazines, great prices. They've even got the Hillary special. Guns80.com, that's 844-2-GUNS80, Guns80.com.
This is Free Talk Live. Call in toll free. 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-FREE.
This is Free Talk Live. You may join us. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. 855-450-3733. Joining you in the studio tonight, you have Ian.
And Mark.
We've got all kinds of cool stuff on our website. Don't miss that over at freetalklive.com. I was doing a lot of Bitcoin outreach today here in beautiful Keene, New Hampshire at the Music Fest. Handed out hundreds of Bitcoin flyers. And, of course, a big question that I received was, well, where do I get these things, these Bitcoins, this international currency that wasn't created by any bank or government, no government involvement whatsoever in Bitcoin, and it's an amazing currency. One of the best places to do it, ExpressCoin.com. And why is ExpressCoin the best option? Well, because if you use code FTL, then you can get up to $40 worth of cryptocurrency, including Bitcoin. They have some other options there, too. You get your Bitcoin up to $40 worth with no transfer fee when you use code FTL. And you know, everybody else is charging you 3-10% to do a Bitcoin transfer. ExpressCoin will do it for free, less than $40 worth, with code FTL. You go over $40 worth, you get a low fee of just 3%. At ExpressCoin.com, it's fast, safe, easy, and inexpensive. You can even do it from your smartphone. Whether you're in the U.S. or Canada, they can probably help you at ExpressCoin.com. Don't forget coupon code FTL, like Free Talk Live. As we go to your calls and thoughts, Brent is listening in Indy to WIBC. Hello, Brent.
Hey, guys. Hey. I just had a really, really quick comment because my phone's about to die.
Sure, go.
My only question about the blue car plan is, how does that not stifle the tax base if people are pulling out to be able to have the blue car? Because you said that they don't have to pay into social programs.
You know, they wouldn't pay into social programs, but they wouldn't get them either. So if a social program can't stand based on the amount of money that's going in, then what good is it?
So the social program will go away if it can't be funded by the people who stay on it?
Yeah, I mean, that makes sense to me, sure.
Yeah, shouldn't people be able to opt out?
Well, I mean, no, I definitely do. I just guess that there's certain folks who would need it, who aren't abusing it, who would lose it if it can't be funded. That would be my only question.
Well, it would be funded. Don't you think most people would? I mean, if these services are any good, people are going to want to have them, so people would continue to get them, right? Like, you wouldn't get. Don't you want your Social Security?
Yeah, but if the blue card makes me tax exempt in certain areas, I might opt for that in something else.
I guess you're on your own then.
Yeah. Well, thank you guys.
Good call, Brent.
Really enjoyed the show.
Welcome aboard. We appreciate it, and thanks for listening there in Indy to WIBC.
Yeah, you know, I mean, obviously, this is what he's pointing out is that what if really rich people opt out and take this blue card, knowing that they're never going to get paid less than minimum wage or these sorts of things, and. You know, I see how that's essentially how a state works, right? Like the state has to rob from the with the social welfare systems that we have today. You basically have to take a bunch of money from the highest echelons and give it to the lowest echelons. So I don't know. I mean, if you don't want to let people who make more than $100,000 a year out, you ought to write your congressman.
I love this blue card. Maybe you should rename it to the secession card. Because
it's like freedom. Call it the freedom card.
Which, of course, why it'll never happen.
Put red, white, and blue on it. People will love it then. The conservative lady will think it's great.
Lewis is also an indie listening to WIBC. Hello, Lewis.
Hello there.
You're on the air. Go ahead.
Hey, you know, a conservative is a person that is responsible for his own self and his own actions, right?
I don't know. I was asking you what a conservative
is. I like that.
Is that what you consider a conservative to be?
Right.
Okay. All right. That's cool. Anything else?
As far as your blue cards go, why are these people coming over here? Why don't they stay in their own country and work very hard to change that?
Have you ever tried to change a government?
Pardon me?
Have you ever tried to change a government?
Well, I think we changed one in 1776.
We had nothing to do with that. Neither you nor I were born. Reasonably certain none of us were born at that time.
1776, wasn't that as a result? Hold on, wait a minute. In 1776, wasn't that as a result of people coming to another place to try to make a better life for themselves?
They did.
Yeah.
They invited the French in to help, too. Yeah. They rebelled against their government.
So why shouldn't people be able to move somewhere else and make a better life for themselves? I mean, if I want to go somewhere else and make a better life for myself, if I think I can have a better life in New Zealand or Costa Rica or wherever, shouldn't I be able to move there?
Well, I think you ought to go today.
Well, no, actually, I like New Hampshire. I'm just fine being here. We
picked up and moved from Florida in order to move for the Free State Project, which is a project to move 20,000 liberty-loving individuals to one state to see what that's like. So we've really already done that.
We have moved further than the average person will likely move for anything. Yeah.
What do you got a problem with people coming to the United States for? I mean, didn't your ancestors come here for a better life?
Well, I just don't. I just don't trust people. You say they won't want our services and stuff because they won't be paying into them. They're not supposed to be getting them now, and yet they are.
Oh, a lot of them don't, actually. A lot of them actually pay into the services but don't collect them.
What number is that?
I don't know.
We don't know. They're here illegally. How are you going to count them?
If only 10% is getting them, what can we do about that 10%?
I say, give them the opportunity
to
work.
Look,
dude, if you put out a bowl of cat food every morning, you can't complain that cats come and eat it.
Well,
you got a welfare problem. You don't have an immigration problem.
Are you a welfare-loving conservative?
Welfare?
Yeah, you support welfare? Government welfare?
I support helping people out for a time.
Okay.
To get through a hard time.
Yeah, I think it's fine to help people out, but do you support doing it through the government?
Not really.
Okay.
Me either.
Good. So let's abolish welfare. So we're on the same page. You and I, we agree about that. Let's get rid of government welfare. Let churches and charities and interest groups, people who care about others, take care of other people who need help.
How are you going to do that?
Well,
how are you going to stop the immigrants from coming in?
Why don't you build a wall?
Oh, God. Are you serious?
Let's put motion tracking machine guns on it, too. And drones. Well, we need drones.
How far deep do you want to build the wall?
Stopping them from coming in.
How far deep do you want to build that wall?
Well, you ever hear about the wall in Guatemala?
I don't want to know about that wall. I'm asking you how far deep this wall should be.
All the way.
All the way to the core of the earth?
No, dear. All the way from one border to the other.
Sir, that's not the question I asked you.
I asked you
how deep the wall should go. Underground. You do understand people can tunnel, right? Have you heard of tunneling before? You go in under the dirt.
They can fly over it.
Yeah.
They can bore a hole through it.
Right. So how's your wall going to stop that exactly? Your precious wall. How's it going to work?
In other words, we ought to just give up and let them just come on in and
giving a plan that will grow your economy and make you wealthy and have people pay into your social welfare programs to keep you into Social Security, and you're complaining that brown people don't talk right.
Well, I paid into the Social Security for 48 years.
That doesn't mean you'll get it. The government took all your money already.
He sounds retired.
I know that.
Well, then I'm trying to solve your problem, and all you're doing is grumping.
He wants a wall, damn it.
No, yeah, look,
a wall.
Look, the fact is we've got illegal immigrants here from China, and they've got the Pacific Ocean to keep them out.
Do
that
you want a wall
didn't
there?
Work. Can you make a better wall than the Pacific Ocean, sir?
Should there be a wall on the Pacific Ocean?
What you need is a dome all over America.
Thanks, Lewis. Appreciate it. I think we stumped him on that one. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE.
You can't just build a wall, by the way. You have to populate it with government bureaucrats with guns. This is what conservatives won't say. Conservatives claim to be for small government, but they love government bureaucrats that carry guns and hoses, by the way. I'm a fireman, and I can tell you the conservatives... Yeah. Conservatives love themselves a good uniform.
Anything that shoots some water, shoots some, whatever.
Projectiles.
Yeah. All right. 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. That guy said, Lewis, he said being a conservative meant being self-sufficient.
And you don't need a wall in that case.
So is that all that it means to be a conservative? 855-450-FREE. This is Free Talk Live.
For P150, P150GA, P150OK, P150TN, C250A, C250E, C250Q. Not available in all states.
What's the scariest thing about going to the dentist? Opening your mouth or opening your wallet? Because just a simple cleaning can cost $100, and things like root canals can cost you hundreds more. If you don't have dental insurance to help, call Physicians Mutual Insurance Company, 1-800-809-5580. This isn't a discount plan or preventive-only coverage. This is real dental insurance that helps pay for checkups right away, so you can call today and get your teeth cleaned tomorrow. Plus, it helps cover the more expensive procedures you might need down the road. Fillings, crowns, bridges, even costly dentures. There's no deductible and no annual maximum. Your acceptance is guaranteed for one of these insurance policies, even if you're retired. There are no networks, so you can choose any dentist you'd like. Call in the next 10 minutes and we'll rush you a free information kit with all the details. 1-800-809-5580. That's 1-800-809-5580. 1-800-809-5580.
No way. Is that a real bullet necklace?
No, it's a 9mm bullet necklace with matching earrings, you'll notice.
Those are awesome. Where'd you get them?
Dave found them at PatriotNecklace.com.
Wow.
They have a variety of calibers and necklaces and earrings and keychains.
PatriotNecklace.com?
PatriotNecklace.com.
Your choice of caliber bullet includes a rugged American-made stainless steel dog tag chain. A percentage of every sale goes to military and service-related charities. And get a discount by entering GCN at checkout. Show your patriotism and support our troops with a bullet necklace from PatriotNecklace.com.
Paid non-attorney spokesperson, Adam Pulaski of the Pulaski Law Firm with principal office in Houston, Texas, is the attorney responsible for the content of this ad. This ad is not legal advice, and the choice of a lawyer should not be based solely upon advertisement. Services may not be available in all states.
Attention Xarelto users. If you or a loved one took Xarelto and suffered a serious bleeding event, you may be entitled to financial compensation. Xarelto is a popular prescription blood thinner used to prevent blood clots and protect patients from strokes. These serious bleeding events have led to numerous cases of hospitalization and even death. Phone lines are open 24/7. Call 800-261-0937. That's 800-261-0937.
Owe $10,000 or more to the IRS?
Get on board with the Tax Admiral! Don't pick on the IRS alone! I'll cut penalties and reduce your overall tax bill sometimes! I can even get it zeroed out completely!
We're an A-rated company helping people clean up their mess with the IRS.
If you owe $10,000 or more, then call the Tax Admiral!
Call 800-287-7180. Again, that's 800-287-7180. 800-287-7180.
Hi, this is Mark Edge, host of Free Talk Live. We've been witnessing a meltdown of the very economic engine that powers this country. With a printing press tethered to Washington politicians, bureaucrats, and central bankers, how can we put our trust in paper money? For years, I've been buying gold and silver from Midas Resources, and you should too. Come see gold.freetalklive.com or call 877-357-9938 for a free book titled 10 Reasons to Own Gold. With Washington, D.C. delivering more debt and printed promises, common sense tells us the future of the trend is obvious. Everyone listening should visit gold.freetalklive.com or call 877-357-9938. I trust Midas Resources for my gold, silver, platinum, and you can too. Again, I want you to have this book, and it's free. It's gold.freetalklive.com or 877-357-9938. 877-357-9938.
We use mobile devices right against our bodies every day, but growing scientific evidence has emerged showing serious health risks associated with exposure to EMF radiation emitted from these devices. The solution is Defender Shield, the most effective mobile radiation shielding ever developed. Defender Shield blocks virtually 100% of EMF radiation from cell phones, tablets, and laptops, and starts at just $64.99. Buy now at DefenderShield.com. For 10% off, use promo code GCN. DefenderShield.com, the worldwide leader in mobile radiation shielding.
You're listening to Free Talk Live. Call in toll-free at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-FREE.
This is Free Talk Live, and you may join us here on our toll-free lines at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. You can also join us via Skype. Skype username here is lrn.fm. Just send along a contact request on Skype. We'll approve it, and then once you're approved, easy for you to call us from that point forward on whatever topic you might, although obviously immigration is a hot topic, what with Donald Trump out there pounding the pulpit about it and getting people all whipped up into an anti-immigration frenzy because, well, immigration or immigrants sure are a convenient scapegoat for politicians, aren't they? You can just blame all the problems in America on those people who are just trying to come here and make a better life for themselves. And then if you can create this scapegoat for people to blame all the problems on, maybe they won't figure out it's actually the government that's screwing them over.
Yeah, I think that's accurate to some extent, right? Obviously, you know, if people come here and use social welfare programs that were not put in place for them, that is going to make the average person grumpy because the average person is working hard for the money that they have.
So is the average immigrant from the ones I've known.
But the average government bureaucrat essentially is part of the parasite class, as is the average politician.
Parasite meaning they don't actually produce anything of value, but instead just siphon off productivity.
Right. I mean, you know, there are certainly government jobs that produce things that we need. Mm-hmm. We just don't know from a market standpoint what they're worth because they're not competing in the marketplace.
Let's go to your calls and thoughts. You can join us here, and let's talk first to, I believe, Don. Is Dan or Don? I can't even read it. Dan, I think. Dan in Newport.
It's Dan in Newport News.
Welcome, sir. Go ahead.
Virginia. Thank you. And you guys have been kind enough to take my call several times over the years in the past, and I love your show.
Thank you.
But
it's our pleasure.
Tonight, I would like to disagree with your blue card just a little
bit. Go right ahead.
And first, I'd like to say that I am not a conservative. I used to have friends that were conservatives, but I tried to convince them to send their Social Security checks back because they were self-sufficient and they wouldn't do it. And they could talk.
Well, they paid into Social Security. I think it's a program that they deserve to be able to take their money out of.
Well, I think so. Well, it's actually not their money; it's other people's money.
That's
it's
true. They already spent your money.
Well, they took your money and spent it. That's absolutely true.
Secondly, in all your kindness, I'd like to say that as far as the immigration issue, we have been really heavily involved. That means that in Virginia, we know that the number one overstayed immigrant or illegal, I guess, as some people like to call them, immigrant in the state of Virginia is actually Russian and not Mexican.
Interesting.
But we have paid coyotes. I don't know if you know what a coyote
is. Yes, a coyote is a human smuggler.
We have actually paid coyotes out of our own pocket, not out of taxpayer money, to help people get here or to help people return for to Mexico or wherever for a funeral or whatever. We have.
When you say we, you mean you personally?
We meaning me and my wife.
Okay.
Our own money. So, yeah, it means we personally. We have also worked with ICE, which is Immigration and Customs Enforcement, on people who have had ICE knock on their door because one of their neighbors have reported them. We have harbored those people with the consent of ICE, who has told us, hide those people until the heat passes and then send them home. So we've done all this. So we know what we're talking about, okay? And tonight I'd like to disagree with your blue card just a little bit, if you don't mind, because, first of all, all of these conservative people, I'm going to go conservative for just a minute, and a free market economy unfortunately depends on capitalists being able to get the cheapest labor that they can get, and so they always threaten us. We're going to go here, we're going to go there to where the cheaper labor is, and people in the countries where the cheapest labor is not are starving. And They have to go to where the work is in order to provide for their families. Sometimes that's America, sometimes it's the European countries, it's wherever it is. And sometimes those people are down there inviting people. And I'd also, gosh, you guys are giving me time tonight. I just really
But I don't know what you're disagreeing on. Is it that if the minimum wage could go, if people who came here could work for less than minimum wage?
Here's a problem that we have right now. Okay, people coming in from the Soviet countries, the Soviet bloc, they'll come in here to Virginia, and they are allowed to receive less than minimum wage in order to work. They come for the summer, and then they overstay their visas.
Okay, and most illegal immigrants in this country have overstayed visas. It's like 70%. Most have not snuck across borders.
Right, that's absolutely correct. What happened with that was during the second Bush administration, both Bush administrations have been very immigrant-friendly. And then the second Bush Jr. said, listen, we've got a problem. These conservative people are really turning the tide against immigration. So you all are going to have to go to D.C. or wherever, your local community, and get registered so that we can get you processed through and make you legal. This happened, 7 or 8 years ago. Well, before Obama, obviously. And what happened was the system became so flooded that all these people have overstayed their visas. Legally, they should not leave, because once you leave, you're out of here. Okay.
Where's the disagreement?
What part do you disagree with? Focus like a
lady. You got to answer that question, or we got to let you go.
Okay, the two parts I disagree with.
Just one. Just pick one.
Okay, one is the minimum wage. No, you have to work for a standard minimum wage. Otherwise, everybody's wages go down.
So people, what you're saying is then that you believe that people should be forced by the government, by the threat of violence, to work at a certain wage.
Yes, I do.
Okay. That's a shame. It's really sad.
Do you think that people who can't speak the language and haven't, don't understand the social mores and norms of a particular community are worth exactly the same amount as a person who does understand the language, has been here for a long time, and perhaps trying to feed a family, that kind of thing?
No, I do not. But I believe that they should be allowed the opportunity to market to their own community when communities are growing. And also,
I think that's great. Thanks. I got to go. Let you go, Dan. We got a lot of people that want to talk here tonight. Let's go to Denny listening in Indianapolis. You're on Free Talk Live.
Hey, I just wanted to say, as a liberal, there were a few things that I might change, but I honestly haven't heard a better plan for the immigration problem.
So, recap, Mark, for people just tuning in, what plan is this?
Yeah, this is my blue card, as opposed to a green card, right? Everybody's sort of a green card. This is a new fictitious plan that I've come up with to stop jobs from being exported overseas, to grow the economy, and generally make America a much better place. And it's first, you got to stop all the foreign wars, because if you are doing a bunch of foreign war stuff, you're going to have people who are trying to sneak across the border and do harmful things to you. People are already concerned that ISIS is here. I don't know if there's proof of that or whatever, but this would stop that. Issue an apology too. We're sorry for being involved in your business, so get out of that.
Blue card.
Next, create an immigration classification called the blue card, and it would make people with blue cards would be ineligible for any government assistance. The minimum wage would not apply to them, and they could not vote. They also wouldn't be required to pay into these government programs that they're not eligible for.
Sign me up. What do you think, Denny? You down?
I like most of it. I like the last caller. I think the minimum wage should continue to apply. And I think, I don't know whether he's saying they don't pay any taxes or just not Social Security.
Well, I just think that they shouldn't have to pay for programs that they don't use.
Right. Yeah. Like Social Security, Medicaid, stuff like that. If they're not getting it, no, don't pay for it. But like the basic taxes that do pay.
How can they get a job if they're competing against you for minimum wage? And I don't know, but there are people like you and I that are working for minimum wage out there. How are they going to compete?
Well, I mean, people are hiring.
People what?
I mean, honestly, I go down to the local McDonald's, and I mean, they're not really speaking English either. They're speaking.
They understand Big Mac.
Weird language. Yeah.
Yeah, so do most of the Hispanics that I talk to. You know what I mean?
Look, the fact is I go to the McDonald's and I'm being served by, and admittedly I'm in the Northeast, but I'm being served by, in some cases, middle-class white people. So who speak English very, very well. Yes, I have gone places where it's a lot of Hispanics working there. I'm just saying that you make it very difficult for a person to, when you put a minimum wage in, what you're doing is you're putting a floor on productivity. The reason jobs are being shipped over to foreign countries instead of being produced here in the United States by minimum wage workers is because they can get things produced cheaply enough. They're actually growing pork in the United States and chicken in the United States, shipping it over to China for processing, and shipping it back.
Here.
That is just how messed up the labor market is in this country.
So, I mean,
the minimum wage is part of that.
Denny, I mean, as a free, allegedly free person, if I want to go and Mark wants to hire me to do some farm work for him at $5 an hour below the minimum wage, well below it, why shouldn't we be free to do that? Why should some government bureaucrat come in and threaten to put Mark in a cage?
Fair argument.
Yeah, I mean, isn't it wrong to use violence against your friends and neighbors just to get them to do something you want them to?
I mean, to be fair, I've never seen anybody get a gun, even so much get a police officer.
That's what's going to happen if you are known publicly as someone who does not pay the minimum wage. You are violating the law, and they will send men with guns after you if you continue to do that after they've sent you a threatening letter.
Every law is enforced by a man with a gun.
Hey, thanks, Denny. I appreciate your call tonight and the discussion. You know, that's the thing, that people don't see it, but it happens if you push the issue. If you decide, well, damn it, I am a free person, I am going to hire someone another free person at whatever rate we darn well agree on, that's illegal, and you could go to prison for it. And to me, that's not freedom. 855-450-FREE. It's Free Talk Live.
It's fall flooring season with incredible deals on the hottest styles right now at Lumber Liquidators Fall Flooring Kickoff Sale. Choose from over 400 great floors with over 20 laminate styles like American-made mahogany for just 49 cents a square foot. More than 30 bamboo floors like carbonized bamboo for only $1.59. And over 150 hardwood floors like pre-finished gunstock oak for only 99 cents. With a dollar off Bellawood, 20% off Dream Home Laminates. Plus gray floors, woodlike tile, vinyl, and more. With 24-month special financing, the Fall Flooring Kickoff Sale is going on now. Visit LumberLiquidators.com to find a store near you.
Before girls' night out, my eczema flared up. Ugh, I felt like canceling. But then I tried Cortisone 10 Eczema Relief. It's specially formulated for eczema and has 1% hydrocortisone, the strongest non-prescription itch medicine for fast, lasting itch relief. It quickly stopped the itch and soothed my red, dry, flaky skin. With Cortisone 10 Eczema Relief, I was ready for girls' night out, and it was the best one ever.
Cortisone 10 Eczema Relief. Feel the heal. Use as directed.
Friends, this is Alex Jones for MidasResources.com. For more than 15 years, I have exclusively used Midas Resources for all my precious metal needs. Whether it's bullion or collectibles you're looking for, Midas Resources is simply the best. I own my gold as a hedge against inflation. This Federal Reserve fiat currency could go the way of the Deutschmark and the Weimar Republic anytime. In these historically dangerous times, it makes sense to physically hold gold and silver. Midas already has some of the best deals in the industry. But if you give them a call and mention the radio special, they will give you a list of the day's super specials. Midas brokers are standing by to answer all your questions at 800-686-2237. They also have a lot of informative free literature explaining the opportunities and risk of holding precious metals. They are ready to answer your questions at 800-686-2237. Again, that's 800-686-2237.
Thank you for listening to GCN. Be sure to visit GCNlive.com today.
News this hour from townhall.com, I'm Ron Rockstra. There's now a reward leading to the capture of three men wanted in the shooting death of a Lake County, Illinois police officer.
Motorola Solutions is pledging $50,000 for a $50,000 reward for information that leads to the arrest and conviction of those responsible.
Motorola Solutions Vice President Ali Kapedia says they're offering a reward because a lot of the employees live in the Fox Lake area. Police Lieutenant Joseph Glinowitz was killed Tuesday while pursuing three suspects on foot. Rowan County, Kentucky clerk Kim Davis will spend a Labor Day holiday in jail after her refusal to issue marriage licenses to same-sex couples.
Frankly, I think it has stunned the American people. It has shocked me.
We did not anticipate that we would be here with Kim Davis in an orange jumpsuit.
Davis's attorney, Matt Staver, says despite his client's surroundings, she's in good spirits and is prepared to stay as long as it takes to uphold her religious freedom. At a campaign stop in New Hampshire today, Democratic presidential candidate Hillary Clinton says she supports the Obama administration's nuclear agreement with Iran, which she called the best alternative we have.
Our strength should be measured in what we prevent, what good things we make happen, and how we bring others to our side in dealing with some of the challenges we're confronting.
In the latest Survey USA poll, Clinton would not fare well against GOP candidate Donald Trump. The poll shows Trump beating Clinton by 5 percentage points. Summer break is over. Congress is ready to get back to work Tuesday. And among the political to-do lists is a fierce debate over the nuclear deal with Iran and a voting a stopgap spending bill in order to keep the government open beyond September 30th. More on these stories at townhall.com.
America was built by people with a few dollars and a dream. And while many don't know it, there's one path to success that still only requires a dream and about $10. That's right. If your dream is to start or grow your business, something as simple as the right business card could make all the difference. And today, at Vistaprint.com, you can get 500 full-color business cards for only $9.99. That's right, 500 business cards for just $9.99. What's more, you can choose between hundreds of designs or upload your own and customize them easily. And because they're from Vistaprint.com, the cards are of top quality and your satisfaction is 100% guaranteed. So visit Vistaprint.com today and get 500 shots at turning your dream into reality. Hurry, because this offer won't last long. To get your 500 business cards for just $9.99, go to Vistaprint.com, click on the link in the upper right corner, and use promo code 2323. That's Vistaprint.com, click on the link in the upper right corner, and use promo code 2323.
A key member of the Senate Armed Services Committee is concerned about a shortage of drone pilots. We get more from correspondent Linda Kenyon.
Senator Martin Heinrich tells Defense Secretary Ashton Carter he agrees in the need for broadened surveillance and intelligence collection. But he writes, "I remain very concerned that the anticipated growth is unsustainable without corresponding growth in recruitment, training, and retention." He also notes that the Air Force is losing drone pilots faster than it can train new ones, saying the force is already stretched thin.
Senator Heinrich is a member of the Senate Armed Services Committee and represents Holman and Cannon Air Force Base in New Mexico, two key drone pilot training locations. A traditional end-of-summer pillow fight by freshman cadets at the U.S. Military Academy at West Point turned bloody when cadets swung pillowcases that had been packed with hard objects. Over 30 cadets were injured, concussions, broken bones, and dislocated shoulders. News and analysis at townhall.com. I'm Ron DeRockstra. A federal judge has denied a bid by a so-called transgender teenager to resume using the boys' restrooms at an Eastern Virginia high school.
U.S. District Judge Robert Dumar in Norfolk denied the preliminary injunction sought by Gavin Grimm, who was born a girl. Grimm filed a lawsuit in June alleging she has been stigmatized by a policy that bars her from using the boys' restroom at Gloucester High School, about 65 miles east of Richmond. The complaint says Grimm used the communal restrooms without incident until the board responded to complaints from local residents adopted a policy in December requiring transgender students to use a private facility. Patrick Foss reporting.
The Chilean appeals court's upholding the conviction of a retired general and a former civilian Air Force employee in the killing of two Americans shortly after the 1973 military coup that overthrew President Salvador Allende. More on these stories at townhall.com. I'm Ron DeRockstra.
Paid non-attorney spokesperson Adam Pulaski of the Pulaski Law Firm with principal office in Houston, Texas is the attorney responsible for the content of this ad. This ad is not legal advice and the choice of a lawyer should not be based solely upon advertisement. Services may not be available in all states.
Attention Xarelto users. If you or a loved one took Xarelto and suffered a serious bleeding event, you may be entitled to financial compensation. Xarelto is a popular prescription blood thinner used to prevent blood clots and protect patients from strokes. These serious bleeding events have led to numerous cases of hospitalization and even death. Phone lines are open 24/7. Call 800-261-0937. That's 800-261-0937.
We use mobile devices right against our bodies every day, but growing scientific evidence has emerged showing serious health risks associated with exposure to EMF radiation emitted from these devices. The solution is Defender Shield, the most effective mobile radiation shielding ever developed. Defender Shield blocks virtually 100% of EMF radiation from cell phones, tablets, and laptops, and starts at just $64.99. Buy now at DefenderShield.com. For 10% off, use promo code GCN. DefenderShield.com, the worldwide leader in mobile radiation shielding.
Free Talk Live.
This is Free Talk Live, and of course, you may call in about anything you want to discuss. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE, although immigration is definitely on the table here tonight, what with the Donald Trump guy going around rattling the saber on that particular issue. There's actually a piece over at Forbes that I'm interested in sharing, if we get the chance, some of it. The debunking Donald Trump's five extreme statements about immigrants and Mexico. But Mark, we started with your proposal, which is actually on our Facebook page and Twitter, about the blue card. It's a little graphic thing that you or somebody else made, one of our Facebook wizards behind the scenes.
I wrote it. They made it and edited it. Yeah.
And let's see here. Basically, your proposal is to create a new immigration classification, the blue card, which would make the person who has the blue card ineligible for federal government assistance and at the same time also not require them to pay into those government assistance programs.
They also wouldn't have the minimum wage laws would apply to them.
And could not vote.
Right. They couldn't vote and they wouldn't be, for instance, they wouldn't get free hospital, free schooling, free other things. All these things they'd have to provide for themselves inside their communities, or charities would have to, could do that too.
And you say that's
And they did for a hundred, before the progressive era in the United States.
Mutual aid societies, for instance. Now, you'd say this will result in more productivity because jobs are going to stay here in the United States. Maybe even manufacturing could return here, considering they could then make negotiations for wage at whatever rates that they're willing to come to, right? Like an employer and a potential employee should be able to meet and have a conversation and decide this is the right pay rate, that the government shouldn't get involved in this. Let's go on with your calls and thoughts. There's also been some discussion of the minimum wage going on here as well. First up, we got Becky on the line in South Carolina listening to WRNN. Hello, Becky.
Hi.
Hi, you're on the air.
Yeah, well, I just wanted to answer a couple of your questions that you sure. asked other people. Well, one of them is to define a conservative. I would think people believing in the original documents that the founding fathers provided and trying to protect and uphold them.
And I'm sorry, and trying to protect what?
The founding documents, the Constitution, the Declaration of Independence, those kind of things.
Because we believe they really do work. And they
so
work
then,
for
as
a long
somebody,
time.
And look, I like a lot of the things in the Constitution. I used to be one of those constitutional guys myself until I became a voluntarist. But I wanted to know, like, in the Constitution, they don't actually mention immigration. So, therefore, as a supporter of the Constitution, you truly support the idea of free people being able to move here and be, you know, have a better life for themselves, right? Like, go seek that for themselves.
Well, let me just answer the other question that you asked the other man. Yes, I believe if they want to come over here and work like our founding fathers did, because they had nothing. They were willing to sacrifice for what they believed in and what they wanted. They didn't try to mooch off
people. Awesome. So you support the blue card program?
Define it.
Well, I did.
We'll do it again. Go ahead, Mark.
Yeah, the blue card is basically anybody would be able to come here and receive the card. They would check in. They'd give whatever identifying information that that they had to give in order to get this blue card. It should take about 15 minutes. Then at that point, that should be their last coming in contact with a government official unless they're speeding or something like that. And they won't be eligible for any kind of welfare. They won't be able to vote. And they won't have to pay for the programs that they are not eligible for.
I think that would be maybe a start, but I don't think it's as simple as that. I really don't, because we are a nation of caring people, and I think that's part of our nature as Americans. We're hard workers. We're not moochers, but you know, we want to take care of somebody if they got sick here, and so I wouldn't make it as cut and dry as that.
Well, no, this wouldn't prevent people from taking care of one.
This has nothing to do with we. This has to do with the government. You and I can get together and help people who need help.
Oh, okay.
Right. Yeah. So, okay, cool. So you're on board. Good deal.
I don't know. I really, I'd have to. It's like
something to think about. Hey, thanks, Becky. Yeah. I appreciate hearing from you tonight. And then one of the other questions we were asking tonight
I'll take, by the way, a constitutional, you know, I would love to see things rolled back to the constitutional republic. I just don't think it's possible. Yeah. I think that we have the government that the Constitution results in because this is the government the Constitution has resulted in.
It is a flawed document, and this government is incredibly flawed.
I don't know
flawed.
How you could argue anything else. People will say, we've failed the document. Well, if you failed hemp paper, man, then I don't know what to tell you. If you're claiming that I have somehow failed the hemp paper, I don't know what to tell you. The fact is the Constitution was supposed to be an agreement between the federal government and the states, and the states and the people, right? And it's not, because they didn't stay within the bounds of that document. So therefore, I didn't sign this crap.
Yeah, null and void. Let's go to, and they act like it's null and void, right? They only give it lip service.
Right. The only time they say Constitution is when they want to hold you in check.
Let's talk to Steve. He's in Indiana listening to WIBC. Hello, Steve.
How you doing?
Welcome, sir. You're on the air.
I was calling. I'm thinking some of your callers are having trouble playing along with the blue card. You know, they're talking in today's laws, today's, you know, the way things are today, that the blue card wouldn't work. So I'm on board with what you're saying with the blue card. It goes to being accountable to yourself. If you choose not to pay into Social Security, like you said earlier, you won't have it. And if you grow old and didn't save any money for retirement, that's your fault.
Yeah, that's true. You know? Although I would point out that even if you do choose to pay into Social Security, you might not have that either.
It is the worst investment, retirement investment that is available to you.
Absolutely. You know, but I mean, you're accountable to yourself. Like you said about if somebody can come from a different country and cannot speak our language and can take your minimum wage job from you, that's probably your fault.
Absolutely.
You should have done something different in your life. And, you know, hopefully there's still time to change it. Maybe there's not. I don't know.
Only imagine that's the way it was for, like, the blacksmiths. You know, when people went from horses to cars, imagine how many people sort of went out of business. But you didn't hear anything about it because there wasn't this sort of cacophonic labor union kind of thing going on. So it's just, you know, I guess I'm going to have to change what I do.
Yep. Time to move
on. That's right. And, you know, and then as far as the defining a conservative, I think so many people are in the tank, Democrat, Republican, what people are calling conservatives as far as the politicians standing up saying, I'm a conservative because I'm going to blame immigration or immigrants for our problems. There again, I think a true conservative is somebody who will hold theirself responsible for their own life. You know, I don't think we've seen a true conservative in the government in a long, long time, probably.
I liked Ron Paul. I felt like Ron Paul fit the bill better than most have. Generally, I tend to agree with you.
Well, Ron Paul's a libertarian,
but he was.
But is he, there? Oh, hold on, Steve. That, is there anything else that defines conservative? Because somebody else called with that same definition, like that you should be able to take care of yourself, and I'm fine with that. But I would not describe personally as a conservative because generally, when I think of conservatives, I think of people who are very socially intolerant people.
And I don't see, and that's why I define conservative the way I define it.
Mm-hmm.
I don't define one way or the other as far as political parties go. I don't define myself because I've yet to find the person who's going to stand up and say, you know what, you're responsible for yourself, and you're responsible if you have a sick neighbor and your neighbor dies of starvation while you're obesely overweight, that's you too.
Yeah.
You know, I think that, I think maybe if we didn't pay so much in taxes, people would be more generous.
Well, this is the most generous nation on earth, so I think there's a lot of support for what you're saying because you know they're already Americans already willing to give more than any other place.
Even when they're being taxed, certainly they'll give more without being taxed. I think you're on board. I'm on board with that, Steve. I like what you're saying. Thanks for the call tonight. I appreciate hearing from you. Obviously, though, I would never apply the label conservative to myself because of what it means to most people, right? Like, right. And I wouldn't use the word liberal, even though libertarians historically have also been classical liberals as well. It's just because people are confused by these terms, and a lot of, you know, people are just not on the same page about them at all across the board. And I also agree that Steve is probably never going to find a politician to say those things.
I also would say that Steve probably never votes for Democrats.
855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. This is Free Talk Live, the live Saturday edition. You can join us and bring up whatever you want.
Are you suffering with hearing loss? Are you sick of people constantly complaining that your TV is too loud? Are you tired of asking people to speak up? Would you like to hear more clearly, but you don't want to wear a hearing aid that makes you look old? Then you need to try Listen Clear, a life-changing breakthrough precisely designed by top audio engineers to fit your ear almost invisibly. And you can adjust Listen Clear to find the perfect way to hear everything, wherever you are and whatever you're doing. And right now you can try Listen Clear absolutely risk-free with free shipping. We'll even give you free batteries for life. So call now, 1-800-719-9349. Listen Clear is lightweight and completely hassle-free, and it's practically invisible. Call for your 100% risk-free home trial with free shipping and free batteries for life. For free information, call now, 1-800-719-9349. That's 1-800-719-9349. 1-800-719-9349.
Is negative content or comments on the web affecting your personal or professional reputation? Unfavorable comments, embarrassing pictures, videos, legal documents, and bad tweets can ruin your personal life, your career, or your business. It happens a lot, and it's just not fair. But what can you do? Reputation.com can protect your good name. Get a free consultation now at 800-831-0771. That's 800-831-0771. Call right now for a free expert reputation analysis. It's easy to squash the unfair attacks with our patented system, and the analysis is absolutely free. Make the best things about you jump out in searches. Protect your personal and professional reputation, your business, and your income. Get your free reputation analysis from Reputation.com right now. Call 800-831-0771. 800-831-0771. 800-831-0771.
Owe $10,000 or more to the IRS?
Get on board with the Tax Admiral! Don't take on the IRS alone! I'll cut penalties and reduce your overall tax bill sometimes! I can even get it zeroed out completely!
We're an A-rated company helping people clean up their mess with the IRS.
If you owe $10,000 or more, then call the Tax Admiral!
Call 800-287-7180. Again, that's 800-287-7180. 800-287-7180.
Thousands of people seeking home security get ripped off every day, and the home security industry wants you to believe that's your only option. They've got hordes of salesmen out there trying to scare you into signing one of their long-term contracts. You get stuck writing huge checks month after month with no way out. It's robbery by contract, and it can cost you thousands. But there's a better way to protect your home. SimpliSafe Home Security. SimpliSafe has no contracts. None. You'll get award-winning 24/7 protection. Security professionals watching over your home, ready to instantly send police to the rescue. For just $14.99 per month. That's less than half what most companies charge. Protect your home the smart way. Visit SimpliSafeDefense.com today for an exclusive 10% offer and get a free keychain remote worth $25. Only when you go to SimpliSafeDefense.com. SimpliSafeDefense.com.
Silver has always been nature's very own antibiotic, and only one system allows you to produce an endless supply of nano-sized silver solutions right from the convenience of your home. Silver Lungs. With the addition of our unique lung delivery system, respiratory infections are targeted directly, where traditional oral administration simply cannot reach. This pioneering method also preserves the original particle sizes and delivers your silver solution directly into the bloodstream. See the Silver Lungs generator and lung delivery system at silverlungs.com. That's silverlungs.com.
Now more Free Talk Live. Call in toll free at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-FREE.
Talk Live. You are invited to join us here on the radio waves at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Also Skype. No Skype callers yet tonight. We've got that open for you. Skype username is lrn.fm. With you tonight, it's Ian.
And Mark.
And Mark, speaking of mutual aid, we were talking about how people could organize themselves in that way. That seems like what Liberty Health Share is.
That's what it is. It's a mutual aid society. And mutual aid societies have been around as long as the nation. They worked very, very well.
They still will work well.
During the progressive era, they attempted to institutionalize some of them. And once you put politicians in charge of things, they tend to go awry. And that's why we have all these problems. So Liberty Health Share is a health sharing organization, meaning that we share the costs of people's bills to get health care bills together. This is what insurance does, but the health sharing organization cuts out all that overhead. We've got several insurance companies in town, and they got a lot of people that work there.
Well, are they subject to the same regulations? I don't imagine they are, right?
I don't know all the specifics, but I can tell you
they're not an insurance company.
I can tell you that, you know, you can pick your doctor, you can pick your hospital, and you're going to have your bills covered the same way that you would otherwise. There is something that's equivalent to a deductible. They have different terminology for everything because it's
they're
different.
Not an insurance company.
Right. It functions similarly, but it is not the same. And for me, my family, it's about half the price of the insurance that's now mandated by Obamacare. This was a solution for us that we could afford. It's the website, and I encourage you to please go take a look, libertyhealthshare.org. It's libertyhealthshare.org, and I've got a telephone number too, 855-58-LIBERTY. libertyhealthshare.org, 855-58-LIBERTY.
We've been discussing immigration, although you can bring up whatever's on your mind. Let's go right into your phone calls and thoughts. Let's go to Glenn, listening in Williamsburg to WNIS. Hey, Glenn.
Yes, I was just going to say, who's to blame for the immigration? It is not our current president, but Mr. Trump should know all about what I'm going to say. In 1983, there was an economic summit held in Cancun, Mexico, and Mr. Ronald Reagan did agree in a consensus to take 50 million Mexicans off of their over-heavy population at that time. And I believe Mr. Fox was the president of Mexico at the time.
Vicente Fox?
I believe it was, yeah. Research that for me. But anyhow, the consensus was they wanted 50 million pronto then. The agreement was no, 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 but continue the trickle, including if we have to government move them with our C5As and so forth. So that fence is going to do no good, and this is law.
So you're saying it's a government conspiracy?
That's right. It happened at the economic summit, which all of us remember very well.
Now, you said 50 million?
50 million was the figure.
Do you know how many people live in Mexico?
That and the consensus was that would vacate some of your cities. We can't do it en masse.
This was in the early 80s?
83,
he said. It is happening today, and we only at 15 to 20 million, I believe it is, since that economic summit.
I mean, according to the population graph over on Google, when you search for population of Mexico, it shows you actually over time it increasing, and it gives you the 1980, roughly the numbers from the early 80s. It looks like the population of that time was closer to 75 million people. That doesn't really make much sense. Why would they want to export 50 million out of 75 million people?
It was so imbalanced at places that they had to do something pronto. But we did not agree to the 50 million lump. Continue the trickle and accelerate it and string it out.
It doesn't. Who is proposing this 50 million number?
Ronald Reagan at the economic summit in Cancun.
So the Mexicans said you can't have 2/3 of our population, but Reagan said gimme, gimme, gimme. Is that your proposal?
No, they wanted to ditch off on us at that time because they were.
You see, that doesn't. That's
they
what
wanted
doesn't
to ditch 50 million
sense.
People.
That's what doesn't make sense because a government. Listen to me. A government is essentially a human livestock tax farm, and there's no way. That's what politicians are. Is they're tax livestock farmers, and so they wouldn't want to get rid of their livestock in the same way that a chicken farmer isn't going to say, here, take 2/3 of our chickens. Now, in the case of Mexico, I would say that they do see a benefit of people going to work in the United States and sending money home, but I just can't agree with your number. It sounds ludicrous.
Well, it's their number. Excuse me. Research it.
Okay. Just didn't even understand what Mark just said.
We're not even close to that 50 million yet, so beware.
Oh, I'm not going to beware. I'm not worried about people coming here to make a better life for themselves.
I like tacos.
Thank you for the call. Gracias, Glenn. 855.
Pronto.
450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. I think that what you said there, Mark, deserves a little more explanation. The idea being that why would politicians want to get rid of their livestock? Why would they want to get rid of the people they're extracting wealth from? They're extracting productivity from. That's why countries make it hard to leave. They don't want you to leave.
The United States has an exit tax.
Yeah.
Which, by the way, is just proof that you're not free. If you can't leave for
without
free,
paying.
You are not free. that's what they do all around. They take a portion of your labor. It is the state is it's a descendant of the master master slave paradigm.
Yeah.
I mean that's what a master did. A master said, "Go work at this. I will take the fruits of your labor, and I will give you clothing and housing and whatever."
Right. Now you get to pick your own vocation.
Now, and you get to buy your house and do all these other things, but they take about 30% of what you make.
Yeah.
And they say, "You better be happy, and if you don't like it, you can go to Somalia." And
30%
is a sycophants to say.
30% is a conservative estimate. You must only be talking about income tax.
That's
there,
about
right?
Because
if you factor in all the taxes you pay, I've heard it comes to over 50%.
That's when you're averaging it out per person. Rich people throw off the numbers. The median person pays somewhere, and we're talking about 30%.
I'm talking about tax on your water, tax on your electricity, tax on your gasoline, tax on
Let's call it 30-70%.
Okay.
But the fact is, it's not worth arguing about this because somebody will always come up with another number.
Yeah, that's true.
The government obfuscates.
They take whatever they feel like they can get away with.
The government
obfuscates
as much as they possibly can in this area, so you don't know how much you pay. But at the end of the line, the regulations that they put in place are far more onerous upon you than the tax burden. Actually, I mean that stops.
And there's a lot of cost involved in
that stops
those
productivity.
Things.
And all I'm proposing in my blue card plan here is to free up labor. Labor's a commodity that people buy and sell. When you put things like minimum wages and regulations and taxes and all these things on it, you stifle the commodity. If you want to have a vibrant economy, you free up labor, you're going to have it.
Let's go to Pete. He's in Newport listening to WNIS. Hey, Pete. Pete.
Hi. I got two different points.
All right.
One is you asked earlier about what a conservative is.
Yeah.
I think that I am really a conservative because I don't spend more than I make. And I think that the government should not spend more than it makes.
I'm with you on that one.
And
stand by. I want to hear more. Stand by. More with Pete. And your calls and thoughts are welcome at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Your thoughts on immigration or what does it even mean to be a conservative? What does that mean to you? This is Free Talk Live, the live Saturday edition.
No way. Is that a real bullet necklace?
No, it's a 9mm bullet necklace with matching earrings, you'll notice.
Those are awesome. Where'd you get them?
Dave found them at PatriotNecklace.com.
Wow.
They have a variety of calibers and necklaces and earrings and keychains.
PatriotNecklace.com?
PatriotNecklace.com.
Your choice of caliber bullet includes a rugged American-made stainless steel dog tag chain. A percentage of every sale goes to military and service-related charities. And get a discount by entering GCN at checkout. Show your patriotism and support our troops with a bullet necklace from PatriotNecklace.com.
This is Dan Pilla. Do you owe the IRS money you can't pay? Are tax debts crippling you? I've defended people from the IRS for over 30 years. I've helped thousands, and I can help you too. I wrote the book on IRS settlement, and I'm telling you, there's no such thing as a hopeless case. Call 800-34-NO-TAX to finally get free of IRS debt. With the IRS's new programs, there's never been a better time to solve your problem. Call 800-34-NO-TAX. That's 800-34-NO-TAX or my website, danpilla.com.
Don't complain about your cable bill going up and up and up. Do something about it. Grab a pencil and jot down this special number. 1-855-905-MY-TV. The more cable TV rates go up, the better digital satellite TV looks. Say goodbye to the cable guy. And get more of your favorite channels in 100% digital quality for less money. Call 1-855-905-MY-TV. Sign up for packages starting as low as $19.99, and there's no equipment to buy. You get free HD TV upgrade, a free DVR upgrade, and free professional installation. You control what you watch, when you watch it. Record your favorite shows. Pause and rewind live TV. Even skip the commercials. Watch local channels too. At just $19.99, what are you waiting for? Pull out your major credit or debit card. Call 1-855-905-MYTV. 1-855-905-MYTV. Say goodbye to the cable guy. Cut costs and get more. 1-855-905-MYTV. 1-855-905-MYTV.
Hey, Berkey Guy here. Are you still drinking unfiltered tap water? Does your water contain chlorine or fluoride? Will you have drinkable water in an emergency? The Berkey Guy is here to help you remove these and other potential contaminants from your water, thus helping you drink clean, purified water. We offer Berkey water purification systems at the lowest available prices online. Don't go another moment without Berkey system. Over the last 10 years, we've helped thousands drink clean, purified water. Join them by visiting goberkey.com or call me, the Berkey Guy, at 877-886-3653. That's 877-886-3653.
Are you tired of commuting to a job that makes someone else rich, working harder than ever, but getting nowhere? Do you hate spending hundreds of dollars every week on daycare, having someone else raise your children? With our opportunities, you can start earning money as soon as next week. You get to be the boss, work from home, and live a happier life. At Be The Boss Network, you'll find hundreds of work-from-home opportunities that you can literally start today and be earning money as soon as next week. Go to freedom106.com and start earning money as soon as next week. You get to be the boss. Get out of the rat race. Work from home. Go to freedom106.com right now and change your life today. That's freedom, the number 106.com. Go to freedom106.com and start earning money as soon as next week. You be the boss. Go to freedom106.com.
We are a survival company. We manufacture our own line of Level 3 and Level 3A body armor. We proudly make our armor 100% in America. We have the best prices in the nation, about $125 cheaper than our nearest competitor. All lab certified. For thou art my rock and my fortress, Psalm 31:3. We are Fortress Survival LLC. .com.
This is Free Talk Live. Call in toll free. 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-FREE.
You can join us right here on the radio at 855-450-FREE. 855-450-3733. We're doing Free Talk Live. That's the name of the show. I'm Ian.
And I'm Mark.
We've got a website. It's freetalklive.com. You can enjoy all the features waiting there for you for free. If you're online, then you need to know about ProXPN. Whether you're on your tablet, your smartphone, your laptop, your desktop computer, Windows, iOS, Mac, Android, Linux, whatever operating system, ProXPN can work for you. It is a virtual private network, and they do it right, offering OpenVPN, the gold standard of network encryption. That's right. They encrypt your internet connection, so your own internet service provider won't know what you're doing online. That means they can't sell that data. That means they can't turn that data over. They can't mine the data.
They must hate that.
They don't have the data once you start using ProXPN. And you can go there right now at proxpn.com. They got more servers than ever before around the globe, giving you greater speed and security. Plus, ProXPN keeps, this is super important, no logs of your activities. And you keep hearing about how your privacy is being infringed online. You go to proxpn.com right now, use code FTL50, and you can take back the privacy that is your right. That code gets you 50% off of the regular monthly price for the lifetime of the account when you buy their annual account with that code FTL, like Free Talk Live, FTL50 at proxpn.com. So we go to the phones and the fun. I think we still have Pete on the line here. Pete, you're back on Free Talk Live. You were talking about being a conservative.
Hello?
Yes, sir. You're on the air.
The point I was making before is that you asked what a conservative was.
Yes.
And I think that I am a conservative because I do not spend more than I make. And the thing of it is, the government should not spend more than it makes.
But the government can actually make money. So they just print it out. Is that a conservative thing?
No, the government should not be printing money to take care of its own problem.
What should the government do?
As far as money goes.
I just mean in general.
As far as money goes?
Well, I'm trying to. Here's the way the government makes money is it borrows, uses treasury bonds or, you know, these treasury notes and borrows money from the Federal Reserve at interest.
And they just print it out.
And then the Federal Reserve prints the money and then the government uses the money and puts it in place. But that since there's interest on the money that they borrow, there is absolutely no way for them to spend what they make because they're actually. They're spending before they make, so all their spending's done in advance. The country has never not been in debt at all. Some people would argue that under Jackson in the early 1800s that it was, but I would say that in fact we're still carrying debt from the Revolution.
Well, I tell you what, that's just really a wrong concept altogether.
Yeah, sounds like the government itself isn't a very conservative organization. Never has been,
nor has any politician. Apparently,
no, it never been conservative in my aspect.
I wonder why Rush Limbaugh keeps telling us to vote for Republicans.
Hey, Pete, thanks for your call tonight, man. I appreciate hearing from you. Let's continue here. And by the way, we've asked this question before in the past, and I have to say, I think we're getting some of the best answers tonight.
Yeah, I would agree with you that it's better than it has been.
Usually when you ask what's a conservative, it's like all over the map what people say.
And liberal, too.
Yeah.
You know, like terms have just become sort of team-oriented terms. They don't really mean much anymore.
Let's continue here. 855 450 free. Daniel's in Myrtle Beach listening to WRNN. Hey, Daniel.
How are you doing this evening, sir?
Go ahead with your thoughts. We're great.
I consider myself the same as the other gentleman. I'm a physical conservative. I don't so much conform with the social side of the Republican Party. I call myself an independent. I can go either way. But
so you would support social freedom? And also
yes,
fiscal conservatism.
Oh, yes, sir.
You might be a libertarian. And just saying.
No.
No?
No, not. Trust me.
Why not?
But I just, I like order. I'm too.
Huh?
Order?
What does
I
that
like
have
order
to do with a libertarian?
Libertarians tend to have a little bit of chaos running around them.
Whoa. What does that mean?
But I don't, there's nothing wrong with it. Don't get me wrong, okay? I'm just a very structured individual. And it's hard to explain.
I would say that doesn't mean whether you're structured in your personal life or not has no bearing on whether or not you're a libertarian. Libertarians are generally very socially free-minded people, but also fiscally conservative-minded people.
If you're fiscally
well.
Conservative and socially liberal, then you tend to fit the definition of what a libertarian is.
So do you think the government should be going should be forcing people to do things against their will?
No.
Okay. I mean, you sound pretty libertarian to me.
Anyway, go ahead
with your thoughts.
But as far as your blue card theory, it wouldn't float here in the United States. We can't even get people to agree to show some type of identification to vote.
Yeah, I won't do that crap.
But you're talking about giving somebody a card to where they can come here and work. And
the idea behind the card would be that, okay, Mark, let's re-summarize this for folks.
For the blue card, somebody from a foreign country wants to immigrate to the United States. We have a different classification for them than the green card. I'm calling it the blue card. It's imaginary. In this imaginary program, somebody takes about 15 minutes to give them whatever identification it takes to walk in the door. So they have to, they don't give the identification, they don't walk in the door. The welfare laws don't apply to them. They don't have to pay for them. They certainly don't receive welfare. They also, the minimum wage laws, they don't apply to them. And basically, those folks, they come here and they're not allowed to vote. So they're allowed to work. They're not allowed to take the welfare programs. That's the idea.
And the thing is, you know, when I'm thinking about this from the perspective of an immigrant, because it sounds like you're still worried, Daniel, that people are just going to come in anyway and they're not going to get the blue card. Now, again, nobody's going to implement this
No. That's not what I'm saying. What I'm saying is, in order to ensure that somebody has a blue card, you have to have some type of proof. In other words, you're going to have to ask them to show that card. When he goes to apply for a job or whatever, you're going to have to ask them to show that they're eligible for that. Okay, and then you're going to have people.
Why would you have to ask? Why would you have to ask?
Well, because there's several people here that are American citizens that have foreign accents. So if you walk in and just naturally assume he's from another country, you're discriminating against him.
Well, if a person wants to, I don't understand why they would have to ask. You see, are you expecting a lot of illegals here? Because I'm thinking the illegals want the blue card and they're just going to go to work.
I want the damn blue card.
I know. Tell me about it. I saw my check today. I wouldn't mind not paying them either.
Hey, thanks for the call, Daniel. I appreciate hearing you tonight. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. Look, the idea behind the blue card would be you wouldn't have to pay, you would not necessarily be subject to minimum wage. So, of course, you'd need to show the card, right? Like, if I came in and applied for a job and I had the blue card and I told, I told you, look, I'm willing to work for less than minimum wage, you'd be like, whoa, I'm going to need to see your blue card first,
okay,
right?
Fine.
So, what's the problem with that? I don't see what the issue is. Going on. 855-450-FREE. Greg, listening in Indy, you're on Free Talk Live.
Hello.
Hi, Greg. You're on the air.
Okay. Guys, I listen to your show every weekend.
Welcome.
It's a great show.
Thank you.
This is what I have to say. The blue card idea, it works. Here's the problem. They have it in China. How do I know? I've been to China. I was in Macau. I've traveled the world, and I've been a couple places. You can look it up. In Macau, China, they have the Venetian, and I built a show over there for Cirque du Soleil.
Wow.
And they have a blue card system, and it works the exact same way that you are explaining right now.
Wow, Mark, where'd you get this idea?
It's going to work.
Well, I actually took it from, part of it was taken from Gary Johnson, the former governor of New Mexico, who recently ran as the Libertarian candidate, but I didn't know that it worked elsewhere.
Well, that's interesting, and Greg, if you've got more to say.
It totally works.
Greg, if you've got more
it
to say,
totally
stand
works.
By. We'll bring you back here.
Okay.
Our toll-free number is 855.
You know no American cares whether it works in a foreign country or not. They're like, I don't care whether
it's... Still, though, that's great. That's a great acknowledgement of this concept. Of course, it'll never be implemented here because it would mean less control for the politicians. 855-450-FREE. It's Free Talk Live.
Every once in a while, you get information that's worth changing your life for. This is one such time. You can save up to and beyond 25% on all purchases at Amazon. You probably heard of Bitcoin and just not thought much about it. You certainly know that you can get competitive pricing at Amazon, but now you can get a 25% discount on nearly everything you need to live. I've just given you a huge raise, and all you have to do is claim it. You go to purse.freetalklive.com and open an account. Do this right now, don't wait. Then you fund the account with Bitcoin. You can buy them through expresscoin.com with a check or money order. There are other ways to get Bitcoin, but that's fast, safe, and easy. This information is worth you changing the way you do things. Go to purse.freetalklive.com right now and get signed up and cash in on the huge raise I'm offering you. 25% off of everything on Amazon through purse.freetalklive.com. It's purse.freetalklive.com.
We the people grow cotton, weave fabric, engrave ink, embed strips and fibers to protect from counterfeit, then carting to a private bank, having it lent back at interest, forcing taxes to service debt. This capitalism, or was Jefferson correct when stating a central bank issuing the public currency is a greater menace to the liberties of the people than a standing army? Ted Anderson, I'm placing a free silver dollar in a book that explains our monetary system. Call for your copy, 800-686-2237. It's time to understand the system. Call 800-686-2237. That's 800-686-2237.
KatieArmor.com is your one-stop shop for the most affordable body armor, period. With packages starting at $169.99 and free shipping on every order, Katie offers soft armor and rifle threat rated armor up to level 4. Go to KatieArmor.com and get your body armor today while you still can. Mention this ad and receive a free tactical scarf for a limited time with any body armor package. That's CATIArmor.com. Come and take it.
Okay, open your mouth and say, ah.
Ah.
When your child has a sore throat, you need to know when to get help. The doctor-recommended Say-Ah Sore Throat Exam is your solution. The scientifically designed oral retractor offers a clear view of the throat, relaxing the tongue and minimizing gag reflex. Compare with a medical-grade chart, website, and app. Then you'll know just what to tell your doctor. A wellness plan in your hands in minutes. Go to SayAhNow.com. SayAhNow.com, the new mainstay for every family's first aid kit.
Mike Stenerson for Midas Resources. At no time in history have precious metals been more important, certainly not in my 22 years in the industry. The dollar has lost over 90% of its value in the last 60 years. No fiat currency has ever survived the government printing presses. Ours is not immune. The time is now to be proactive. 1-800-686-2237, extension 116. Anything tied to the dollar is at risk. CDs, annuities, 401ks, IRAs, stocks, bonds, you name it. So decide. Do you want to leave a legacy of wealth or debt for your family? The choice is yours. Call me at 1-800-686-2237, extension 116. That's 1-800-686-2237, extension 116. Be proactive, not reactive. Call 1-800-686-2237, extension 116.
By now you know that wireless technology like cell phones do in fact pose dangers to the health and privacy of everyone. Blockit Pocket's wide range of products are unmatched in providing the protection you deserve. No scare tactics, just common sense. BlockitPocket.com offers quality American-made options to alleviate and eliminate these invisible dangers. Learn more at BlockitPocket.com or call 888-315-9618. BlockitPocket.com, enhancing health and privacy.
You're listening to Free Talk Live. Call in toll-free at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-FREE.
It's Free Talk Live, and you can dial in toll-free here to join us on the airwaves at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. We've got Skype. Skype username is lrn.fm with you in studio. You've got Ian.
And Mark.
Let's go right back to, I believe we still have Greg in Indianapolis. He was talking about Mark's idea of this blue card program, which would essentially allow people to come here, make a better life for themselves, and opt out of paying into the federal government's programs, but also it would mean that they would not be able to receive any benefits from those programs. Plus, they would not be able to vote, and I feel like I'm missing something else.
Minimum wage wouldn't apply to them.
The minimum wage wouldn't apply. So, Greg, you're back on, and you say this has worked in China.
Yes, sir. It worked. I was there in 2008, September 8, 2008, until the recession, where it actually skipped Macau, and nobody worried about the recession. It hit America hard. It skipped Macau, China, and then it hit us harder than an F5, where my contract got cut. So I lived there for 2.5 years on a blue card. There were people from England. There were people from the Philippines. There were people from Australia, and there were people from America. This is how it works. They give you a monthly salary, and if the job is available, okay, you can apply. They can hire you or they don't have to, but you have to qualify for the job. You go in the country, they give you a blue card, and the blue card lasts for a year. After the year, they renew it automatically.
Sweet.
Okay, so it's a year-to-year basis, and they renew it. You have a person that's in charge of it, like a, I don't know, supervisor, secretary, whatever. And they let you know, hey, it's time to renew your blue card. And as long as you're not a criminal And as long as the jobs are available, they give you the job. And you're on a salary basis. I was earning $5,500 a month there.
Wow.
Now, here's the kick, okay? You pay taxes to their government, but you do not get taxed from your government in your country. Does that make sense?
It does. So, well, a United States citizen will get taxed if they make more than like $100,000 a year or $200,000 as a family.
But through this blue card system, we pay tax to the Asian government. We didn't pay tax to the American government.
You probably weren't making enough.
We were tax exempt. So, yeah, that's exactly right. But, you know, I was in China. It was 8-1.
Five grand a month is pretty good money.
Oh, I'm not claiming $5,000 a month is bad. It's right. It just doesn't qualify.
And
for
were you? I imagine you were also right. paying China living prices, so you're probably socking most of that away, right?
Yes, absolutely.
Wow.
I mean, you can go to the store, right? You have to, when you're in another country, you have to think like you're in that country. They had Western markets. But why would you go to a Western market when they have the exact same thing in an Asian market?
For a fraction of the price.
Okay, so you go to the Asian market, and you, like on that island, they go by pataka. Okay, so 100 patakas was at that time were $12.50. But in Asia, 100 patakas is like $100.
Huh.
You understand? Wow. So you can go and fill your cabinet. For 100 patakas.
It's incredible.
You just go to the free market. You buy their groceries. So you
now this blue card. I'm curious, Greg. The blue card in China, is this a Macau thing only, or is it all across China?
I'm pretty sure it's across China. If you're an expatriate, you have to go and apply, and they give you some type of card. Now, Macau was independent from mainland China. But I'm pretty sure it was the same system.
It's a great, interesting story. And thank you, Greg, for taking the time to call and tell it to us tonight. Thank you. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. Slightly different from your blue card, Mark, because your blue card did not require the person to pay into the federal government system.
Well, I would think that if I did say that you didn't have to pay for the programs that you didn't use, but if uh-huh. you're using, you know, if there's some program or another
What would that be?
I don't know. I mean,
what federal government program
I don't know,
do you use?
Oh, I'm talking about state and local. I mean, obviously, people are driving on the roads, so gas tax would apply, right?
Oh, if you're getting a cell phone, and,
you know. Like,
yeah, I guess I didn't ask Greg specifically, like, which government were they paying the tax into?
Different governments are different in the way that they, you know, apply these things.
Yeah.
So, you know. Anyway, another thing that was different about this the blue card over in China is that you needed to renew it every year. I don't see any particular reason for that. I can see why they might make the blue card program, if you get a felony, it immediately revokes your blue card. But I do think that they pass out felonies far too regularly here in the United States.
Yeah.
I would say that if there's not a victim, then there hasn't been a crime, in my
Absolutely.
Opinion.
Toll-free number tonight, 855-450-FREE. Let's go to Pete. He's in Newport, Virginia. You're on Free Talk Live and listening to WNIS. Hey, Pete.
Hi. If we had a flat tax system, I'm sorry.
That's all right. Flat tax. You want to talk about that? Because I'm fine with talking about the flat tax.
Yeah, I mean, the flat tax, I mean, if we had a flat tax and everybody paid the same amount, then...
Well, it would certainly be easier to administrate that. Pete, thanks for the call. It sounds like you're kind of freezing up on the air, but it's scary to call talk radio.
It does.
I appreciate his effort.
When I call other people's shows, sometimes I'll get that feeling, and I get it. And, you know, best thing to do, it's practice.
Yeah,
you
no
get
doubt.
Better with practice and talking about these things.
Flat tax.
The flat tax, okay, so I like the idea of the flat tax. I don't like the idea of any taxes. As far as I'm concerned, politicians are a parasite class, and them claiming the fruits of your labor it's just theft.
Yeah.
However, if we're going to talk about which forms of theft I prefer,
right.
I get why the flat tax is preferable. It seems efficient in several ways. However, we have a constitution in the United States. The constitution is a set of rules. The 16th Amendment says that income tax is the law. The last thing I want is a flat tax and an income tax.
Oh, yeah, that's right.
So
yeah.
I would first, before you're going to get my support for your flat tax, you're going to have to repeal the 16th Amendment. And that would be the requirement that I would see. Also, we need to consider that in the United States, many people, let's see, I did the research back. It's been some years since I've done the research, but in 2009, 144 million tax returns were filed. 144. There were about 300 million people in the United States. Somebody wouldn't file their taxes. So basically in the United States, if you don't want to pay and you work for yourself, it's possible. I mean, there's tens of millions of people in the United States who are not filing tax returns.
I'm not.
Yeah, I know you're not.
And you can go to hell.
See, I don't think I... Yeah, if you make less than tax advice. If you make less than $14,000 a year, I think you don't have to file. So
I don't have to file because I say so. They can go bite me. 855-450-FREE. That's the toll-free number. Because if you're a free person, you shouldn't have to send back anything to these people. These are strangers, as far as I'm concerned. The IRS is a violent group of strangers. And I understand that's why most people will file, because they're scared. They know that that violent group could turn against them at some point, and then they might be thrown into a cage. And that's a relatively uncomfortable thing for most people, so they'll just go ahead and pay it. But kudos to everybody who is not paying into that horrible, tyrannical system. I have serious moral objections to paying into that system. I also happen to be a minister with the Shire Free Church, so technically ministers don't have to pay those things. But I didn't pay for years. I mean, it's been a decade now that I haven't paid federal income taxes. And I have a serious objections to what they do with that money, like killing people around the world with it. And I can't bring myself to support a system like that. Toll-free number, 855-450-FREE. If you want to join us here on the radio, 855-450-3733. And by the way, Mark, somebody sent me a letter actually during the Porcupine Freedom Festival, which was a copy of some IRS snitch form where they had filled out my name and information on the IRS snitch form as though that was somehow intimidating or something like that. It's like, hello. I mean, I talk about it on the radio that I don't pay these taxes.
Yeah, I think it's absolutely ridiculous. The detractors out there, they seem to think that things we talk about on the radio are secrets. Like, I have revealed a long time ago that I'm a convicted felon, and I put the information was out on our website, and people went and found it on our website, and then they posted as though it's a big surprise. Mm-hmm. Well, yeah, we got you. No, Mom, you didn't get me. That information was on our website.
Donald Trump's five extreme statements about immigrants in Mexico. There's a neat piece over at Forbes that is debunking those statements. I'd like to share some of it if we get the chance. And we've got plenty of time for you to share with us your thoughts about whatever's on your mind at 855-450-FREE. Whether it's taxes or immigrants or whatever you want to discuss, you may take control of the airwaves here. 855-450-3733. We've got Skype as well at Skype username lrn.fm.
Are you searching for your soulmate? Someone you can trust, who will never betray you or cooperate with the NSA? Stop searching. With EasyDNS, you found a keeper. EasyDNS does it all. Domain names, web hosting, and managed WordPress hosting. EasyDNS stands up for your internet freedom, and with servers in Canada, they do not cooperate with the NSA. Go to EasyDNS.com. You'll love their services or get a full refund. They guarantee it. And they accept Bitcoin. That's EasyDNS.com.
Here's a good idea. When you have a legal matter like creating your will or legally setting up a business with a corporation or LLC, you don't necessarily need a law firm. Use LegalZoom.com. At LegalZoom.com, you answer straightforward questions online and they take care of the rest. They even review your answers for common mistakes and guarantee your satisfaction. Free Talk Live listeners, you'll get 10% off your order by typing in FTL in the referral box at purchase. Don't procrastinate with these important legal documents. LegalZoom.com.
Gold isn't for you? Ted Anderson, president of Midas Resources, one of the world's premier gold and precious metal investing firms. I get it. You wouldn't buy gold if you believed that the government is doing a great job, that the Fed will stop handing out trillions of dollars like bailout candy, that Social Security would be there for you. That's not what's happening. You might even pass on gold if the stimulus package wouldn't fuel inflation, or that the dollar wouldn't lose value, or that your retirement would be secure. If all looks rosy to you, then now is not the time to buy gold.
For the realist, there have never been more sobering reasons to diversify with gold. Since 2001, the U.S. dollar index has tanked 30% while gold has risen 300%. Right now, savvy investors are adding gold to their portfolios. You should too. Find out what they know. Call us and I'll send you 10 reasons why gold will do very well, free. 800-686-2237. 800-686-2237. That's 800-686-2237.
Thank you for listening to GCN. Visit GCNlive.com today.
News this hour from townhall.com. I'm Ron DeRocha. Memorial service was held today in Vancouver, British Columbia, for three members of a family from Syria who drowned while sailing from Turkey to Greece. They drowned after piling into an overloaded boat in Turkey headed for the Greek island of Kos. A picture of a young boy on the beach sparked global outrage about the plight of refugees in Europe. Folks heading out for summer's last fling at Fox Lake, Illinois, will see a large police presence after the murder of an officer last week.
Especially with this holiday weekend, we're expecting an influx of people out in Chain of Lakes and in the Fox Lake area for the holiday weekend. So in response to that, the Lake County Sheriff's Office and the Illinois State Police are continuing with saturation patrols.
The manhunt continues for three suspects who were being chased on foot by Lieutenant Joe Glinowitz when the cop was gunned down. According to a new poll, Republican presidential frontrunner Donald Trump leads Democrat Hillary Clinton head-to-head.
A new poll released Friday by SurveyUSA finds that matched up directly, Trump garners 45% to Clinton's 40%. The poll surveyed 1,000 adults across the nation September 2nd and 3rd, and it had a margin of error of 3.3%. A CNN ORC sampling of national voters in June found that 59% supported Clinton to 34% picking Trump. Trump's popularity has surged through the summer, while Clinton's has struggled with voters' concerns over her trustworthiness. The poll also found that 30% of respondents believe Trump will eventually be the Republican nominee. Val Dior reporting.
A vast California wildfire burning in Kings Canyon National Park grew overnight, but fire crews hope to gain control since cooler temperatures are expected over the weekend. Fires burned some 134 square miles east of Fresno since it started July 31st. It's 25% contained. More on these stories at townhall.com.
What's the best way to...
Hello, Jacob? Hello?
Can you hear me?
I hear you.
How's it going?
Good. Where are you calling from tonight?
I'm calling from Salt Lake.
And what do you want to talk about?
I just want to say you guys are killing it tonight. I'm loving the conservative questions. And I think that blue card is a great idea.
All right. Stand by, dude. Stand by.
All right. Okay.
Our website has tons of fonts and amazing artwork. And our team of professional inkers will make sure your shirts turn out perfectly. Order one shirt or thousands. On-time delivery is guaranteed, and we'll even ship your order absolutely free.
Start designing your custom ink t-shirts today and see why 99% of our customers say they would order from us again. Visit customink.com.
A top official of Russia's only non-state elections monitoring organization says the group's considering liquidating after being declared a foreign agent.
The Russian Justice Ministry announced it was adding the Golos organization to its list of foreign agents. A controversial Russian law says any non-governmental organization involved in politics that receives foreign funding must register as a foreign agent. The term carries a pejorative Cold War-era connotation, and critics say the law is aimed at discrediting such groups. The law is among several measures President Vladimir Putin's government has taken to clamp down on groups seen as opposed to the government. Keith Peters reporting.
Japan's government on Saturday lifted a four-and-a-half-year-old evacuation order for the northeastern town of Nahara that had sent all of the town's 7,400 residents away following the disaster at the nearby Fukushima nuclear power plant in 2011. News and analysis at townhall.com. I'm Ron DeRockstra. Medical errors have been blamed for up to 100,000 deaths in U.S. hospitals each year. Dr. Charles Schneiderman says information's key to preventing those errors.
Very often, if you go to the hospital, you're not being treated by somebody who knows you well and has had an ongoing relationship with you. So the communication of information is absolutely absolutely essential.
Dr. Schneiderman says electronic medical records could help, but he suggests everyone carry a printed or electronic copy of their own medical history. Top officials at one of the nation's premier federal laboratories say an extensive review has turned up violations in how the labs handled hundreds of containers of radioactive waste during the past decade. Latest revelations are on top of the permit violations the Los Alamos National Laboratory first reported last year in the wake of a radiation release at the nuclear waste dump in southern New Mexico. More on these stories at townhall.com. I'm Ron DeRockstra.
Silver has always been nature's very own antibiotic, and only one system allows you to produce an endless supply of nano-sized silver solutions right from the convenience of your home. Silver Lungs. With the addition of our unique lung delivery system, respiratory infections are targeted directly, where traditional oral administration simply cannot reach. This pioneering method also preserves the original particle sizes and delivers your silver solution directly into the bloodstream. See the Silver Lungs generator and lung delivery system at silverlungs.com. That's silverlungs.com.
So I say to Mark at lunch, look, you know, I keep hearing from the government that, you know, they're worried someday ISIS may get here. And I go, duh, Garland, Texas, Muhammad cartoon shooting, ISIS is already here. I'm not waiting for these people to defend me. If they don't know ISIS is here already, they got no clue, I'm taking care of myself. Guns80.com, AR-15 kits, 30-shot magazines, great prices. They've even got the Hillary special. Guns80.com, that's 844-2-GUNS-80, Guns80.com.
This is Free Talk Live. We got plenty of time for you to join us here on the radio waves on this live Saturday edition with you in studio. It's Ian.
And Mark.
Toll-free number for you to join us here, 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Maybe you want to comment on Mark's proposal for the blue card, which we posted on our Facebook and Twitter. Essentially, the idea would be to make the United States a more productive place that would encourage more productivity, like businesses, manufacturers coming back to the U.S.
Growing the economy, stopping jobs from being exported overseas. The idea of the blue card is instead of a green card, the blue card allows pretty much anybody to come here as long as they, you know, spend 10 or 15 minutes filling out a form, giving whatever their information they have. They can come in. They won't be eligible for welfare. They won't be eligible to vote. They won't be minimum wage won't apply to them.
Yeah, and if you want to comment on that, you're welcome to do so. 855-450-FREE. Let's go to the phones, to the phone. You can bring up anything you want. Doug's in Chicago. You're on Free Talk Live with Ian and Mark.
Hello.
Hey, Doug.
I actually want to bring up an issue. I download your show, an earlier show, and I take it to the gym with me on my phone, and I play it.
Cool.
And I think it had been the other day that, that you and Mark were talking about a gentleman called up, and he had been talking about the EPA. And Mark brought up, well, if I have oil flowing from my property into your property, Ian, clearly I'm violating your liberty and your private property. And I would agree with that. But I wish that Mark would went a little bit further into that, for the fact that we're dealing with today where people claim that, you know, the global warming issue can be, we have to cut back on it due to it affecting their liberty, affecting them. You know, I mean, that would be like the equivalent of Mark having the pig farm. They put out a lot of methane, and then the neighbor complaining, well, you know, you're contributing to global warming, Mark. I think that you should be prevented, you know, from doing that. I mean, I'd like to know how far, Mark, you intend to go with that. You know,
right.
I mean,
when it comes to pollution, it's a very difficult thing to quantify. One of the first pollution lawsuits was some surf types were complaining that the Nobles apple farm was doing something, apple orchard was doing something to pollute their land or whatever. And that's like one of the first in English common law. The difficulty is that, yeah, I'm producing carbon dioxide, and a lot of the science that's coming out these days surrounding global warming says that carbon dioxide's a pollutant. So,
but isn't that what the trees breathe in?
No, trees breathe carbon dioxide and oxygen and expel carbon dioxide just like we do.
Oh, really?
Photosynthesis, however, is a process that converts carbon dioxide and sunlight into food for trees.
Huh. Okay.
It's a good thing you went to the smart school in town.
Yeah. Glad I have you here, Mark. Anyway,
I mean, it pretty much can be that you have people on the far left, and well, not particularly the far left. You have people on the left that are now complaining that you're infringing upon their liberty. You cannot drive a V8 car. You have to have a fuel efficient car. You're infringing upon their liberty. And my definition of liberty can be, okay, with the oil, I would agree with that. I would agree that, you know, you can't have one neighbor pouring oil through a creek into another property.
Mm-hmm.
But you have to have a direct impact. You know what I mean? You have to have a direct impact. You have people now claiming that, you know, oh, well, Mark, you have a pig farm. Methane can be a major contributor to global warming. You know, you shouldn't be allowed to do that.
So I see where you're coming from, and I think you're right about that. And obviously this, I think, speaks to the idea of, well, if we actually do have more deliberate societies in which people move to areas where they're around like-minded people, then I don't think you have to worry about that so much, right? So if we go into a world in which we actually have a more free society, which is what we want on this program, then people who appreciate freedom, like you and I, you know, they'll move to that place. And the people I think the people who want to have the right to sue someone because they have methane coming out of their property because of global warming or whatever, let them move together and sue each other. I think that would be okay.
I'd also like to point out that if you eat pork, that you're going to produce less methane by what you consume than if you eat beef.
Go ahead, Doug.
But to be clear, Mark, you would not be in favor of it, right?
Yes, I would not be in favor of that. What I'm saying is that the problem is the court system we have is essentially a monopoly organization. You get whatever lunatic judge that you're assigned to, and that's the one you get. You don't get to shop around, and there's no competition in the marketplace. If there was competition in the marketplace of arbitration, you'd get better arbitration. We can see that from essentially every good and service that's out there. So I say that you've got to arbitrate in the area of pollution. I don't know what that looks like.
Right. Thanks. By the way, I have no problem. I have no problem with the people that actually are, you know, in favor of cutting carbon emission, and they actually live the way that they preach. You know what I mean? I hold them in high regard. But you have people like Obama and Clinton and Gore that have the carbon footprint of 15 people. I mean, I don't know if people know, but, you know, you don't have a corporation or a company at the number one polluter. You have government. The federal government, they are the number one polluter in the country.
That's true.
I mean, you can take one thing like the data mining. They had to move from Fort Meade out to Bluffdale, Utah, for the fact that they were taking in enough electrical power to make a brownout in Maryland, you know? I mean, they are the number one polluter.
It's true. Doug, thanks for your call tonight, man. I appreciate it. Our toll-free number here, 855-450-FREE. Let's talk to, I think we've got Jacob on the line. Jacob on Skype in Utah. Go ahead, sir.
Hey, how's it going, guys?
What's on your mind tonight?
I just want to call you guys. You're doing a great job tonight. I'm really enjoying the conservative discussion. I was raised in a predominantly conservative household, and so I kind of wanted to address that and the whole immigration blue card thing at the same time.
All right.
You know, being raised in a conservative household, I grew up believing that one of the big principles of conservatism was a free market. And so the ironic part comes when you start talking about immigration, when the fact is immigration is only a threat to a socialist society.
Right.
It's not a threat to a free market.
Absolutely.
Why is that, Jacob?
Well, because the free market, it builds on itself. When you have more people here, more labor, there's a cost to living. They pay for things to keep themselves alive, just like everybody else does. They go to the grocery store. They pay, you know, anything at the store. They pay for utilities. And so, excuse me.
So they're empowering the marketplace rather than leeching from it through some sort of social welfare program.
Yes. And they, you know, and like you said, labor is a commodity. They fill a commodity. They produce things. They help to move the economy along.
It's true. And in fact, a lot of immigrants are actually entrepreneurs. So they bring fresh ideas to the table and start new businesses, which creates jobs and makes everybody better.
Yeah, Milton Friedman is famously quoted for saying something to the effect of, "Is you know, nobody's there's no reason to be scared of immigrants unless you have a welfare state. A welfare state can't support a bunch of people who are coming here." And like I said to the guy who called in earlier, if you put out a bowl of cat food every morning on your porch and then cats come to eat it, you don't yell at the cats because you keep putting the bowl out.
Exactly.
The problem is that you have a welfare state. You've got a welfare problem, not an immigration problem. Immigrants built this country and will continue to build this country if we give them the opportunity
to. Well, unless you turn it into a total police state, in which case they'll just stay home.
Or turn it into a whole welfare state either.
Yeah.
Anything else, Jacob? Yeah. Go ahead.
Nope. I think that you guys are doing a great job. Hey. I love the blue card idea. Think it would be great.
Thanks for the call tonight. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE, or join us on Skype as Jacob did. Skype username is lrn.fm. Let's continue here with Tom, listening in Baltimore. You're on Free Talk Live. Hey, Tom.
Hey, gentlemen.
Welcome.
Listen, quick compliment for the two of you. I turned on your website and was surprised to see that you're actually doing a live show on a holiday weekend, and I don't think there's another radio talking head anywhere proposes to have solid views that's doing anything live. So that tells me, and I, the reason I listen to your show so often, even though about 25% of the time I really vehemently disagree with you.
That's okay.
That's pretty good.
That you have such passion and dedication to what you're doing, and nobody can not respect that.
All right, now you actually get to talk about what you really called about. Stand by. I appreciate the accolades.
I love that he saw it, though, that it's a holiday weekend, because he's absolutely right. Free Talk Live does this 52 weekends a year, 7 days a week,
and we'll be
365 days a year.
We'll be live on Sunday and on Monday.
Yeah.
On Labor Day, we will be in the studio producing live radio for you. We'll continue, and you can join us here at 855-450-FREE. It's Free Talk Live.
I wish I could fall asleep.
Jennifer had a stressful day, and now her mind is spinning at bedtime.
I have a big day tomorrow.
It's time for new Unisom Sleep Knees. The tiny capsules are non-habit forming and work fast. They're the little help busy people need to get a good night's sleep and wake recharged.
Good night.
New Unisom Sleep Minis. A stressful day deserves a restful night. Use as directed. Active ingredient diphenhydramine hydrochloride.
Free Talk Live has partnered with Amazon, the largest internet retailer. Imagine a department store category, and Amazon has it. Books, electronics, office products, furniture, jewelry, automotive, toys, clothing, sporting goods, and dozens of other categories. Now you can shop and support Free Talk Live by entering Amazon through our website. Go to shop.freetalklive.com, and Amazon will send us a portion of your purchase. You're going to do the shopping anyway, so remember to enter through our site at shop.freetalklive.com. That's shop.freetalklive.com.
That's the sound your brain makes when you realize you're buying something and forgot the coupon. Online or in a store, knowing that you're missing a deal is the worst. You need the app from RetailMeNot right now. Get thousands of coupons from 50,000 stores like Kohl's, Domino's, Best Buy, and more with crazy deals like 60% off, free shipping, and free gifts with purchase. You can get a text invite to download the RetailMeNot app 100% free right now for Apple or Android. Just text the code UPDATE to 42767. Then just show your phone at checkout to save. It literally couldn't be easier. It's 2015. Keep your coupons in your phone. Stop what you're doing and text UPDATE to 42767. Listeners will get a text with a link to download it 100% free. Never forget another coupon again. Text the code UPDATE to 42767 right now. That's UPDATE to 42767. Message and data rates may apply. For terms and privacy, visit RetailMeNot.com.
Hi, this is Ted Anderson. Have you ever wondered why banks, stockbrokers, investment advisors won't talk about gold IRAs? They've been available since 1986, yet the financial industry won't recognize the value of gold for your retirement. Gold has outperformed paper investments, yet no word about IRAs. If you would like to have gold for your retirement, call 800-686-2237. Don't get left behind by rising inflation and low returns. Call 800-686-2237. Secure your future and call 1-800-686-2237.
Have you ever felt like the United States government knows way too much about your financial affairs? I continue to hear stories about property seizures, frozen bank accounts, confiscation of stocks and bonds. It makes me wonder if the U.S. citizen will ever again have the right to life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. Unfortunately, with the Drug and Money Laundering Act, the IRS Revenue Ruling 6045 of 1984, and the Trading with the Enemy Act and Franklin D. Roosevelt's Executive Order of 1933, some precious metal holdings are subject to government intervention. For this reason, Midas Resources has prepared a report explaining the boundaries of trading precious metals privately. Whether if you have any intention of trading with Midas Resources or not, I have instructed my representatives to give this report out free. Call for your free copy at 1-800-686-2237. When investing, always proceed with caution. Again, call 1-800-686-2237. Exercise your legal right to trade metals privately. 1-800-686-2237.
Okay, open your mouth and say, ah.
Ah. When your child has a sore throat, you need to know when to get help. The doctor recommended Say Ah Sore Throat Exam is your solution. The scientifically designed oral retractor offers a clear view of the throat, relaxing the tongue and minimizing gag reflex. Compare with a medical grade chart, website, and app. Then you'll know just what to tell your doctor. A wellness plan in your hands in minutes. Go to sayahnow.com. Sayahnow.com, the new mainstay for every family's first aid kit.
Now more Free Talk Live. Call in toll-free at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-FREE.
It's Free Talk Live. Live Saturday edition on Labor Day weekend. Yeah, that's right. We're actually here, and you can join us here toll-free at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. If you have a business, you know that IT can be frustrating, as well as unreliable, unpredictable, and late. But it doesn't have to be. IT can serve your needs reliably, predictably, and on time. RootWork Infotech helps businesses like yours achieve always-on reliability. They're nerds who know business, and RootWork can make IT meet your needs. To prove it, they'll give you 30 minutes on the phone with a senior consultant for free to answer any of your IT questions. Just go to rootwork.it/FTL to get your free call. That's rootwork.it/FTL. rootwork.it/FTL. As we continue with your calls and thoughts. We do still have Tom with us here on the line. Tom, continue here. You're back on Free Talk Live.
Okay, gentlemen. The last caller, by the way, was absolutely right relative to the free market. Unfortunately, we don't have a free market.
No.
And that's where so many of us get hoodwinked, because the honest, decent people who believe that people mostly are honest and decent, and I think they are, we always... or should I say, we often get taken advantage of by the psychopathic liars, which have a tendency to make their way into positions of power.
They sure do.
I think that's been proven by a psychological study, I think several. But I wanted to touch on one point, and I'll let other callers get on. You were talking about taxes, and I hope you guys really pursue what I'm about to tell you. And you probably already know about it. I know that many other people know about it. I work in government, and I ran a department, and I found that my budget was dwindling, and I couldn't figure out where the money was going. And because I was in the police department and a special investigations unit, I decided to get two of my detectives myself to start looking into where it was going. We had to teach ourselves about financial crime because it wasn't our forte.
Mm-hmm.
But what we found was astonishing. And we thought we were onto something huge until we found out that people seem to be aware of it all throughout government. And I've questioned mayors, I've questioned governors, and they admit to it. To me, that's misproving the felony because they didn't seem to do anything about it.
What exactly are they admitting to? Exactly. I know you said your budget was going down, but what were they admitting to?
They're admitting to knowing that the government regularly, and I've never found one government from municipalities to state and federal governments, are keeping two sets of financial books, just like a criminal organization would do.
Mm-hmm.
They put out for the public every year the budget, which we're all familiar with.
Right.
They always tell us we're falling short. You know, we're always in the red, never in the black. However,
That's only a small portion of what the government is actually bringing in. The other set of books, and the politicians regularly refer to it as the slush funds, and that's essentially what they are. However, they're very upfront about it if you look into it.
You're referring to the Comprehensive Annual Financial Report, correct?
Yes.
Yeah.
Trillions of dollars. I mean, it was astounding to me how much money is being earned by the interest in these investments that these corporations, you know, government is a corporation at any level.
Yeah.
These investments that they're making now, your co-host mentioned about the Federal Reserve note being a debt instrument. Absolutely right. However, what they're doing is actually taking money out of the system. They're investing it. They're securitizing real assets, land and other things that you wouldn't believe. Mm-hmm. And they're making a way above what they're paying for to get those Federal Reserve notes. In fact, if you go to the Treasury, and I'm still not completely clear on this, but they talk about being able to exchange Federal Reserve notes for other forms of currency. Now, to me, that's awful strange. I mean, oh, what are you going to do? Give them a $100 bill and say, make change? And when I looked further into it, I found that their definition of currency, of lawful money, in their mind, is one, a demand or an order to pay, which is simply typing some numbers and saying, pay this. And also, for them to, what was the other one? It eludes me for the moment.
Well, I think it's interesting to stop for a moment and talk about the comprehensive annual financial reports. These are relatively esoteric things. You're right. Like, people don't know that they exist, but they're not necessarily hidden. You can get them from your local governments. You can get them, I believe, from the state government as well. And there's a guy who really kind of made a name for himself. I'm sorry, I don't remember his name, so obviously it wasn't that much of a name. But he made a name for himself to some extent by revealing these comprehensive annual financial reports, sort of what they're all about. And so just to kind of restate this, because I don't want to gloss over it, it's a big deal. The budget is only a portion of this comprehensive annual financial report. So there's, as you're pointing out, all this off-budget activity going on with all manner of money and investments and capital, and it's just insane the amount of investments and money that they have behind the scenes. And ultimately, they have plenty of money. If there's a budget shortfall, it doesn't mean that they don't actually have the money. It just means that that's not what's in the budget or whatever. Like, there's other things that are just not in that budget, like the investments that the city of Keene has or the state of New Hampshire or, in your case, Baltimore, Maryland. And they've got all these other things that they don't put into the budget because, well, they don't have to, right?
I was floored by it. Like I said, I hope you guys follow up on it. Let me leave you with one thing, though, that will be helpful to your calls. What struck us was this: the huge conflict of interest with the government being invested in these corporations and mm-hmm. actually bringing criminal cases against the people. There'd be cases you could have actually thrown out and found to be void for fraud because the government actually has a conflict of interest. Now, that's if you could get anybody to actually look at the evidence and be truthful about it, but an avenue for you to look into.
Thanks, Tom, for your call tonight. I appreciate hearing from you. It's something that hasn't been brought up on this show in a while. I don't remember the last time somebody mentioned the comprehensive annual financial reports, but they're real. You can download them. I think I even found one on the city of Keene's website. We live here in Keene, New Hampshire, just to look at it and see what kind of stuff do these governments have? What kind of investments do they have? They've got all these investments, and purportedly some of it's being used for pensions and things like that, as I understand it. But I'm no accountant, right? So I look at these things and I'm like, oh, okay, well, there's big numbers here and I don't really know exactly what to do with it. But there's all this money that these governments have in state governments' cases, billions of dollars invested outside of the budget. It's interesting.
Yeah, I don't know. I mean, what a surprise when you give these organizations the ability to tax, which is to demand money at the pain of your incarceration or the stealing of your house, that they're going to take that money and perhaps not be as entirely above board as you might have thought
yeah.
they were going to be.
It's really super dishonest.
Americans, you think your government is honest? You think your local government is out of touch. Which of your governments, which of these unaccountable people that almost never go to jail for the crimes they commit, which one of them do you think is accountable?
Right. So the what you have happen is these government bureaucrats and politicians bemoan, oh, we aren't meeting our budget. We're going to have to raise taxes. Well, they didn't have to raise taxes. They could have cashed out some of their investments that they had. They could have gotten the money from this comprehensive annual financial report. It shows where all their assets are and what they've got. They've got quite a bit. 855-450-FREE, 855-450-3733. They're taking your money and investing it, and they're not giving you a return.
Hunters, anglers, campers, and survivalists. Get back to nature. Expand your horizons with the highest quality, most versatile, unique slingshots and sling bows on the market at slingbow.com. Slingbow products are compact and models start from just $17.98. They're perfect for your bug out bag or storing in your vehicle. Give yourself and your loved ones the excitement and tradition of slingbow, a new frontier in archery and truly modern twist on this primitive survival tool. Feel the thrill only at slingbow.com.
Turn on the news and you'll hear stories of natural disasters, political unrest, and financial crisis. In times of uncertainty, how will you take care of your family's most basic needs? Food Insurance, America's most trusted provider of freeze-dried emergency food, has solutions that fit your family's needs and budget. Our meals are delicious, nutritious, and come with a guaranteed 25-year shelf life. For a limited time, we are sending a free freeze-dried meal to all listeners of this program. Go to foodinsurance.com and request your free meal today. That's foodinsurance.com.
Okay, honey, I have to ask, and be honest here. Have you been taking a little blue pill? Because things have been pretty good in the bedroom lately.
No, I swear.
You didn't pick anything up at the Pharmacia last month in Cancun?
No.
Well, something's different.
I have been taking that heart and body extract you bought me.
But that's for your heart and to control your cholesterol.
Well, I read HB extract also promotes healthy prostate function.
I never guessed it would work this well,
but... you're glad it did.
Oh, yeah.
Heart and Body Extract is 100% organic formula that promotes a strong heart, healthy arterial flow, better circulation, improves erectile and prostate gland function, and provides youthful energy, strength, and stamina. Find out more at heartandbodyextract.com. Heart and Body Extract, paired with healthy heart choices, is a winning combination. Call toll-free to order or for free information. 1-866-295-5305. 1-866-295-5305.
Piedmont attorney spokesperson Adam Pulaski of the Pulaski Law Firm with principal office in Houston, Texas is the attorney responsible for the content of this ad. This ad is not legal advice and the choice of a lawyer should not be based solely upon advertisement. Services may not be available in all states.
Attention Xarelto users. If you or a loved one took Xarelto and suffered a serious bleeding event, you may be entitled to financial compensation. Xarelto is a popular prescription blood thinner used to prevent blood clots and protect patients from strokes. These serious bleeding events have led to numerous cases of hospitalization and even death. Phone lines are open 24/7. Call 800-261-0937. That's 800-261-0937.
We all know that Berkey Water Purification Systems are the most trusted name in water filtration. As an authorized Berkey dealer for over 6 years and serving thousands of satisfied customers, the Berkey Guy offers amazing specials for Berkey Water Filtration Systems. The Berkey Light Systems include a set of self-sterilizing and recleanable black purification elements that purify water by removing chlorine, pathogenic bacteria, cysts, and parasites to non-detectable levels and remove harmful chemicals such as herbicides and pesticides. Order the Berkey Light System today, complete with two black Berkey elements for only $231, and the Berkey Guy will ship your order free of charge. With the purchase of a Berkey Light, the Berkey Guy is also offering a set of fluoride and arsenic filters for only $39.99. That's over 30% off the retail price. Call the Berkey Guy at 1-877-886-3653. That's 1-877-886-3653. Or order online at GoBerkey.com. That's GoBerkey.com today.
Owe $10,000 or more to the IRS?
Get on board with the Tax Admiral. Don't pick on the IRS alone. I'll cut penalties and reduce your overall tax bill. Sometimes I can even get it zeroed out completely.
We're an A-rated company helping people clean up their mess with the IRS.
If you owe $10,000 or more, then call the Tax Admiral.
Call 800-287-7180. Again, that's 800-287-7180. 800-287-7180.
This is Free Talk Live. Call in toll free. 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-FREE.
Yeah!
It is Free Talk Live. You can dial in toll-free here, 855-450-FREE. With you tonight, it's Ian.
And Mark.
855-450-3733. Bitcoinist.net, the ultimate resource for Bitcoin industry news, reviews, education, and the latest in the cryptocurrency ecosystem. They've got a community forum, breaking Bitcoin and digital currency news. They'll cover fintech and blockchain tech news, and Bitcoinist has very sophisticated Bitcoin network statistics, a solid beginner's guide to Bitcoin, and more. The Bitcoinist platform serves the needs of everyone, including you, looking to keep up with Bitcoin and digital currencies from beginners to experts. Once again, that's Bitcoinist.net. Bitcoinist.net. As we continue, we will take your calls about whatever you want to discuss. JT is on the line listening in Washington. You're on Free Talk Live. Hello, JT.
Hi. I have a bit of confusion over why it only takes 36 senators to pass this Iran nuclear deal.
You are on a, are you on a smart or a like a speakerphone or a headset or something? Because you're kind of fading out on me.
Well, it's complicated. I'm on a cordless phone connected to a Verizon home wireless system.
You're actually sounding all right. Okay, so what about, what was it again?
Well, I listen to NPR and right-wing radio, and none of them have explained to me why it only takes 36 senators to pass this Iran nuclear deal.
Tell me about the Iran nuclear deal.
Well, I don't know much about it. I'm an uninformed American.
Me too.
Okay, so the best I understand of this is that the Obama administration went to the Senate and got some kind of sanction to put together this deal in ahead of time. And so essentially the Senate gave up its power to the executive branch to negotiate treaties. Senates are the ones that the Senate is the one that and ultimately is going to vote on a treaty. But the difficulty is that the executive branch is probably, just has the State Department is more qualified to put together a treaty. So they asked, hey, can we put together this treaty? And the senator said yes. So they only needed a smaller amount. Normally they would need 2/3 or 3/4, and I'm not sure which, but I would guess 66. In this case, they only needed 1/3 to pass it.
But what I understand is it's not a treaty, though. It's an agreement.
Okay, well, if it's not a treaty, it's not part of the Constitution, and it shouldn't have to go through the Senate.
Right. Well, I also believe that if it's not a treaty, all bills should start in the House. Isn't that correct?
Well, Mark, what you're saying is this is an agreement between the executive branch of the United States and the executive branch of Iran. Is that
right?
Well,
I know it had to get passed through the Senate, and they had to get like 36 senators or some number like that. So I assumed it was a treaty. I like I said, I haven't done a great deal of research on this, and I would like to see, as much as anybody, I would like to see some kind of deal put together with Iran, but I wouldn't like to see a bad deal put together.
How about this deal? End sanctions.
Well, I don't know enough to make a decision about it. I mean,
it's okay. You don't get to.
Well, I think that, hold on. I think that you can know enough about sanctions to oppose them, right? Sanctions basically result in people doing things like starving to death, right? Because it prevents folks from being able to do business and interact with people in a particular area, refusing to accept or to send food and other products over to those places. So, I mean, really, are sanctions necessary? Do the people of a particular land need to be punished because their government is bad?
Well, I'm not afraid of Iran myself. Even
great.
If they do develop their bomb, it's going to be an atom bomb, which is really nothing compared to a hydrogen bomb.
JT, thanks for your call tonight. I appreciate hearing from you. Sanctions, Mark, do you think those should end?
No, I don't think that sanctions – I think sanctions are an act of war, and they frankly I bet you're going to have a difficult time finding somebody who's working within the Iranian power structure that's doing poorly as a result. What happens with sanctions is that the individuals, the people, don't do that well, but right. Usually you're talking about pretty tyrannical places anyway. Mm. You're looking at places like Cuba and Iran and North Korea. These are places that are dealing with sanctions. why? I mean, these are already places that are already tyrannical on their people. Do you really expect their people to get up and fight? Because so far that has never happened.
Well, right. And also, it's not going to help those people of that country feel good about the United States.
Sure.
Okay, because they could feel good about the United States if the United States government weren't trying to starve them to death. Right, so let them feel good about the United States by ending sanctions and allowing people to interact with folks in those countries. At the very least, then they could maybe blame their own politicians instead of blaming the United States politicians. I mean, Kim Jong-un and his predecessors in North Korea have constantly been blaming the United States for the problems which were created by Kim Jong-un and his predecessors in North Korea and the ruling parties there. They're blaming the United States for things like blackouts. They say that the blackouts are happening because the U.S. is attacking their power facilities, and we, the North Korean military, are doing everything we can to defer these attacks from these damned imperialists. You know, they can say whatever they want to say, obviously, even if the sanctions end, but at least then the government of the United States won't be contributing to that situation.
And another thing that you have to consider with a sanction, and this is a really important thing. Every American needs to understand this. When the United States puts a sanction on another country, what they're telling you and me is that we no longer have the right to do business with certain people. This is the United States government, the land of the free and the home of the brave, telling you you do not have the freedom to do business with somebody else. And that is fundamentally anti-American. It's anti-freedom.
Yeah.
And I don't even see particularly where it's constitutional.
I'll give you a good example of this. The guys who make the Lamassu Bitcoin vending machines, which are being sold all around the globe and are helping people get their hands on Bitcoin. Actually, you can't get your hands on them, but it's a digital currency. Anyway, Bitcoin is this currency that was not created by any government or bank, and it can empower people if they can get Bitcoin. And don't we want to empower the people of Iran? Well, guess what? You can't sell a Bitcoin vending machine into Iran. These guys that make this Bitcoin vending machine, they're shipping them all around the world. And they had an inquiry from somebody who wanted to buy one from living in Iran. And they, even though they would have loved to have sold it to him to help this guy bring Bitcoin into Iran, which can help undermine the government, basically, because it's not government currency, they're not allowed to do it. It would be a criminal act for them to just simply sell a piece of hardware to that man.
Thanks, United States government.
Right. All right, let's continue here. Steve is listening in Utah. You're on Free Talk Live. Hello, Steve.
How you doing?
Go ahead.
Concerning the vote in the House and the Senate, the 34 votes needed, it was those votes in the Senate, was my understanding, of having a veto proof. So if the House overwhelmingly voted to veto, then the Senate needed 66 votes in order to veto or to override the president's veto on the passage of the bill. That's why they kept saying only 34 votes in the Senate was needed. If he could capture 35 votes, then he was able to sustain.
Yeah, somehow or another, this deal was supposed to be backwards, though. Somehow it had
That's the backward part of it, isn't it? Instead of trying to find votes to pass it, they were trying to protect a veto-proof vote.
Yeah, I can see why Americans are upset that things didn't go through the normal way that they were supposed to go through.
The Republicans' version of saying, no, we're not going to pass this, then it seemed like the 34 votes in the Senate would have given him a veto-proof
margin.
Now, I'm guessing at it. I'm looking for
Well, so is Politico and the Federalists, too. It's not like anybody's entirely clear on this.
I appreciate the info, Steve. Thanks for the call tonight. Appreciate hearing from you. And we do have enough time for you if you want to join us here in this live Saturday edition of Free Talk Live. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. We've also got Skype. Skype username is lrn.fm. Whatever's on your mind goes. This is Free Talk Live.
If you own a business, You know incorporating can be a smart way to protect yourself and your assets. So the question is, why haven't you incorporated your business yet?
My business? It's too small.
Wrong. No matter how small your business, you run the risk of losing all your personal assets, your car, your home, even your entire life savings if you're not incorporated.
Incorporating is very complicated.
Actually, incorporating is easy and fast. You can do it in just 10 minutes. Call now for your free guide from incorporate.com. 1-800-945-8645.
I need a lawyer to incorporate. That's really expensive.
You don't need a lawyer, and we don't offer legal or financial advice. Incorporate.com is a service company whose only mission is helping people like you incorporate safely, easily, and quickly. Find out how simple it is to protect your family and personal assets by incorporating. Call now for your free guide. 1-800-945-8645. 1-800-945-8645. That's 1-800-945-8645.
Are your Google search results killing you? Unflattering content in blogs, news articles, online reviews, social media, or other sources can jeopardize your reputation, your business, and your livelihood. Let Reputation.com help. Our patented technology will make the truth about you more visible while pushing down unwanted negative content. Improve your Google search results. Call Reputation.com at 1-800-831-0771 for a free consultation. That's 800-831-0771.
The human body is more than 60% water. Your brain and muscles are 75% water. And your blood is 92% water. Water is vital to your body, and alkalizing your water is the key to keep it running at its best. AlkaVision Plasma pH drops keep your entire body healthy, boosts energy, promotes weight loss, and even fights cancer. Call 800-518-7615 or go to AlkaVision.com to find out more. That's ALKAVision.com.
We use mobile devices right against our bodies every day, but growing scientific evidence has emerged showing serious health risks associated with exposure to EMF radiation emitted from these devices. The solution is Defender Shield, the most effective mobile radiation shielding ever developed. Defender Shield blocks virtually 100% of EMF radiation from cell phones, tablets, and laptops, and starts at just $64.99. Buy now at DefenderShield.com. For 10% off, use promo code GCN. DefenderShield.com, the worldwide leader in mobile radiation shielding.
Attention, all men. Are you urinating more frequently? Do you wake up to urinate? Are you having a slower, weaker stream? Don't ignore the warning signs of your aging prostate. Get your free bottle of Super Beta Prostate. Super Beta Prostate is guaranteed to support a more complete emptying of your bladder, a fuller, stronger stream, and less waking at night to urinate.
Super Beta Prostate is a product that I really like. I endorse it. I use it myself. I was very pleasantly surprised that Super Beta Prostate helped me fairly quickly.
Super Beta Prostate is formulated with a natural plant enzyme called beta-sitosterol. It's so powerful, you'd have to take 100 salt palmetto pills to get the same sterols as just one Super Beta Prostate tablet. Don't ignore the warning signs of your aging prostate. Call now to get your free bottle of Super Beta Prostate. Call 1-800-853-1203. That's 1-800-853-1203. 800-853-1203.
Just recently, we've witnessed some of the most catastrophic disasters in history. Be sure to prepare yourself with great-tasting, high-quality, GMO-free food that has a 25-year shelf life. Of course, we're talking about the foods from SurvivalFoodAlliance.com. And don't forget, the human body needs up to 3 quarts of water every day to remain healthy and hydrated. So check out our water bricks at SurvivalFoodAlliance.com. Go to SurvivalFoodAlliance.com or call 877-223-1776.
You're listening to Free Talk Live. Call in toll free at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-FREE.
Talk Live. Join us here at 855-450-FREE is our toll-free number. 855-450-3733. Tonight, it's Ian.
And Mark.
We've got a website. You can go to freetalklive.com. Enjoy all the features that we give to you there. If you like the show and you like what we're doing here on Free Talk Live, then please amp Free Talk Live. Go to amp.freetalklive.com. AMP, it stands for Advertise, Market, and Promote. amp.freetalklive.com allows you to send $5 a month into the show via any major credit card through PayPal or Visa or MasterCard right on our website, and that helps us out a lot because that $5 allows us to market Free Talk Live and get on more radio stations all around the country. So if you enjoy hearing us in your local market on the radio, then you can help us get on in other markets on the radio. Or maybe you don't hear us in your local market. Well, you can always call the local talk stations and ask them real nicely to add some Free Talk Live. That's helpful. But the $5 a month helps us do advertising and really reach directly out to those stations as a show and inform them about us. And it really makes a big difference for us. You get perks. You get access to the AMP-only Facebook group, which is really fun. And the AMP-only, there's also the AMP-only forum and the AMP-only podcast. So go and learn more about it and get signed up, please. amp.freetalklive.com. Don't expect somebody else to do it, please, if you really like the show. It's a great way to support us. Let's go to Nate. He's in Mobile listening to WAVH. Hello, Nate.
Hey, how's it going? You know, the sad thing is there is a solution to that wall. The sad thing is, politicians on neither side want to find the solution. And meanwhile, it doesn't matter what side you're on, you should want to seal that border just to stop illegal trafficking of drugs.
I am not interested in a police state.
Well, we can still allow immigrants in through a gate. And, you know, when you go to Walt Disney, you have to give them your thumbprint.
So, I'm not okay with that. That's not freedom. I don't want to look.
I'm as much
first
a
of all,
libertarian as the next guy.
All right. Well, then you would agree that you should end the war on drugs, and then you won't have a problem with drug smugglers anymore, will you?
Well, hey, you know what? America has a serious heroin problem. Heroin.
America has a serious drug war problem.
Think about this. How do you logistically get heroin from Afghanistan to Ohio?
You use the military C-130s.
Oh, yeah. We can wipe them out, but there's really no will.
No. You asked how you get the heroin from Afghanistan to Ohio.
The Mexican drug cartels that have the same, that are using the same logistics and are delivering those drugs over the border,
Nate, you asked the question. You asked the question how you get the heroin over. I said C-130s from the military. I meant they're smuggling it. The military's over there protecting poppy fields.
The ports. It's not through our military, but it's mostly through the ports.
Hey, could you do me a favor?
You were talking about
when you get off the phone. Can you Google U.S. soldiers guarding poppy fields and look at the pages and pages and pages of results that you get of U.S. soldiers in poppy fields around Afghanistan.
If you want to end the heroin epidemic in the United States, and we got a problem with it right here where we live, okay? If you want to end the heroin epidemic, then you need to end the war on drugs so heroin users aren't afraid to go and get treatment anymore. And,
well, you know what?
Yes.
That's another thing. If you're a libertarian and somebody's overdosing, why are you going to you reap what you sow?
Just being a libertarian, sir, doesn't mean you have no soul. Being a libertarian doesn't mean you don't care about your fellow man.
If you see a kid go after a ball in the street, kick him down in front of the car.
If you dig your own ditch, man.
Well, thanks for the call, Nate. I appreciate it.
People are responsible for their own actions, absolutely. But that doesn't mean that I'm going to leave a person, who is, overdosing right in front of me to die. Now, I am a firefighter, so we've gotten a certain amount of life saving training. I probably should have more, but I don't put the time away to do it. I'm going to take care of that as best I can until somebody who's more qualified than me comes along.
This is a really unfortunate misconception about libertarians, and I'm pretty sure it comes from some libertarians, so it probably is to some extent deserved, but obviously it is based on collectivization, so therefore it's not fair. Are there some libertarians who have this attitude of, screw them? Okay, probably. But there are also probably some people in, other political parties who have that attitude as well. And, of course, libertarianism is more
than
just
a political party. No, they just want to jail them.
Yeah. So I think that if you're a libertarian, all that really means is you don't agree with the use of aggressive force to achieve political or social goals. That doesn't say anything about how you feel about helping people in a time of need. And most libertarians I've seen are very generous. There are There are fundraisers that we have here. We moved to New Hampshire as part of the Free State Project. It's a movement of libertarian types and voluntarists who are converging on one plot of land. That plot of land is New Hampshire, and they're getting active. And every now and then there's a fundraiser for somebody who's, you know, fallen on hard times, or they have had some sort of injury, or they're sick.
These things happen.
And these guys pony up, man. They got no problem helping their members of the community. Mark, you and I are both, we donate to the local homeless shelter. There's a privately run homeless shelter here in town. I'm both a monthly and a yearly contributor to that that homeless shelter. And so, you know, the idea, and by the way, that homeless shelter is helping people regularly who have heroin problems. So, you know, the idea that libertarians are this cold group of people who just want to screw them, throw them to the wolves, let them, whatever happens, happen, Darwin, you know, no. No, that is not the case at all. In fact, what we want as liberty-minded people is for the opportunity to actually choose how to help people, to use the money that we earn in the way that we think is best.
The most efficient system. Yeah. Like, that's what I want is, here's what I know. Here's what I know about welfare. Now, you know, obviously every program's different, but on average, you'll find that the charities, you know, it's about 30% of about a third of their stuff goes to administrative costs, and about two thirds goes to helping people. With the government, it's about two thirds go to administrative costs and one third goes to helping people. So you have an organization that is essentially half as productive as a charity. Now, why are you forcing me to go through that system when I could be twice as productive or just as productive with half as much money? The answer is because you want, whether you're willing to admit it or not, is you want a make work program for a middle class government bureaucrat. You believe that the government can create jobs, and it can create jobs, but those jobs are parasitical jobs.
Harley is on the line in Frankfurt, listening to WIBC. Hello. Hey, Harley.
Hey, this is actually me.
Welcome. You're on the air.
We had no doubt.
Oh, shit, I'm scared.
Oh, you can't say that. I think you just said the S word, so we're going to have to hit the dump button on that. Sorry, I mean, we didn't mean to scare you. He said, OS, I'm scared.
I think so.
Why we had, I'm almost 100% certain about that. Our board op actually hit the dump button before I could even get to it.
Yeah.
So, it's scary. It can be intimidating to call talk radio, and I get it. I really do. Like you said earlier, Mark, you just got to practice at it. And one of the best things I would recommend is to write down your points. If you've got something you really want to say on talk radio, and this is across the board, whether you're calling any other show, it's a lot easier to get on Free Talk Live than those other shows. But if you're...
there's no show even live right now. Yeah. How else could you get on another show?
Calling talk radio, number one tip, I would say write down your bullet points. Now, you don't have to write a paragraph of what you want to say, just the most important things that you want to get across. Of course, the fewer things you have, the more likely you're going to get those things across, because most talk shows, the hosts are relatively intolerant towards their callers. They aren't really interested in having a conversation. They're not really interested in what you have to say. Most talk show hosts, they just basically use the callers and they just dump them as soon as they say one sentence, and then the host just rants about whatever it is the person called about. On this show, you can call in and we'll have a conversation with you. Obviously, the more interesting it is, the longer it's going to go. There's no set amount of time.
Yeah, you still have an obligation to be interesting.
But the thing is, you know, a talk show host is pretty good about getting a caller sort of off into a tangent or into another, or deep into an issue or off their original track. So if you want to stay on track and make sure you get your points out, just make a few little notes like, oh, bullet point one, two, and three. All right, then call. And that way, if you get lost and like space out or freak out, you can just look down at your notes and say, oh, that's what I wanted to talk about.
Yeah.
All right. So let's go and give Scott the final word here in Ithaca, New York, listening to WNYY. Hello, Scott.
Hey, it's funny that you said that, because when I call into this one particular talk show, I actually sometimes have notes that I refer to. But tonight will be so quick, I don't need notes.
Okay, good. That's good. You're going to be quick because you literally have 20 seconds. So go.
I believe in a minimum wage with a teenage exemption, because there are countries where they do that and they make it work, and it allows employers the flexibility of hiring underage workers at a slightly lower rate than the actual national minimum wage.
While we're at it, can we also get rid of the minimum working age and allow children to work in the United States?
on places besides farms.
That's up for debate. That's
all right,
up for debate.
Let's debate it another night. Yeah. Thanks, Scott, for your call. And if you didn't get in tonight, no worries. We do a live Sunday show, even here on Labor Day weekend, and we'll also be live on Labor Day. So join us. If you don't get us on the radio, you can always get us online at freetalklive.com. Have a great weekend.
GEICO applauds your inner ride leader.
An enthusiastic engine rev goes out to the biker in you who leads the pack. Even if that pack is a party of one, you're still a leader to GEICO. To prove it, GEICO will insure your motorcycle with great rates and 24/7 customer service. And with GEICO by your side, you're never cruising solo, which means you've just been nominated as a real ride leader. Congrats! The smell of fine leather and trailblazing is in your future.
GEICO Motorcycle. See how much you could save.
If worse comes to worst, will you be prepared? You don't have to be a survivalist to prepare for the unexpected. Storing necessary supplies like food, water, and emergency equipment is simply taking responsibility for ourselves and our families when it counts the most. StrategicShelters.com offers emergency supplies and a secure way to store them, and provides protection for loved ones in the event of an extreme natural or man-made disaster. To find out more, visit StrategicShelters.com.
On the average, Americans work between 45 to 50 years, hoping to build up enough wealth to retire and live out their golden years. Unfortunately, with taxation, the rising cost of food, energy, housing, and medical, many retirees are forced to live below the poverty line. Is this a flaw for the enterprise, or is our monetary unit we call the Federal Reserve Note forcing us into perpetual debt, ensuring inflation and higher taxes? These questions and more can be answered by reading G. Edward Griffin's book, The Creature from Jekyll Island. Congressman Ron Paul states it's what every American needs to know about central bank power. A gripping adventure into the secret world of international banking cartel. Hi, this is Ted Anderson. I will give a silver dollar from the early 1900s to anyone who purchases this book. Call 1-800-686-2237 and order a copy today. It's critical that the public be made aware of the system. Call and order your copy today at 1-800-686-2237. That's 1-800-686-2237.
Listening to GCN, the world leader in independent talk radio.
Brought to you by the Ad Council and Grads of Life.
News this hour from townhall.com. I'm Ron Rockstra. California's biggest wildfire this year is expected to spew smoke through the Labor Day weekend, leaving roads closed and some campgrounds empty.
It's currently at 85,894 acres, which is approximately 130 square miles. So if you put that into perspective, the city of San Francisco is about 60 square acres or square miles, so it's double that.
George Apple, public information officer.